N-D-Y! Yes, sir!
Love it, chicken! Double time!
Miles Turner!
Yeah!
John, I have never been better to be on the air with you here in Indianapolis, a place where so many of my dreams have come true.
The Ride with JMV on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
I don't know. We're still working through it. And I know I'm going to get a lot of questions about Carson right now. And it's a, I don't have a direct answer for you. We're working through it. Jim, Mr. Irsay, and Frank and I will sit down over the next 10 days and figure out where it's going. Ultimately, we'll do what's best for the team, for the Colts, both in the short term and in the long term.
That's Chris Ballard earlier today, the Colts general manager, as he met with the media around 1:30 down at the NFL Combine. Welcome into the show, and we're until 6 o'clock with a lot of ground to cover for you. I'll talk all about that. I want to dive into those conversations and the Q&A that Chris had with the folks downtown a little bit earlier. All right, I'm curious. Here's what I gather. Now, there was also a part where he had side conversations with the locals. So, Matt Conte, the sports information dude for the Colts, stepped in and said, all right, yeah, question's over. And then he had a little side gig, a side hustle working with some of the local folks, and some of the national folks, too, about, in this case, the offensive line. And here's the things that I gathered, and let's see if we're all on the same page with this. And I know we've got some new info here that you guys can work off of, and you're probably saying, man, thank the Lord, because you're sick and tired of talking about the stuff that we have for the past month and a half. But mind you, it is of a similar theme here. We're not going to get away from this anytime soon, or at least until that final decision, not is made, which I believe it's been made already, but made public. Until it goes public, we will be talking about this. It's funny, I mentioned this yesterday toward the end of the show. I had mentioned, because somebody in the YouTube, Inside the Lounge YouTube live chat had said, hey, way to go, middle of the road. And my take has been this. I'm not a great fan of Carson Wentz and what he can do at quarterback for this team to help them win at the highest level. However, when in terms of Wentz in year number one and what you have out there, I kind of wonder where they're going. And I'm not a fan of the lateral move, and I'm not a fan of, you know, going beneath what you already have. So with that conversation, it was, hey, you're middle of the road. Or don't get hit by that vehicle because you're standing in the middle of the road. Let me tell you this. There's nobody more middle of the road right now than what Chris Ballard did an hour and a half ago or less. I mean, it's completely middle of the road. I mean, I don't know what you would expect right now. So you go out and you make this huge trade and you go through the season. And he did mention that it wasn't about the final two games of the season. Well, fine. He also did mention, you know, these shortcomings in Baltimore or against Tennessee or against Tampa Bay. Not just from the quarterback standpoint, but from a whole team meltdown situation. But he did mention that. And even if you don't believe what I've talked about or where this thing is going, I mean, do you question... how in the world they don't know as of right now, the first day of March, you don't know how you feel about the quarterback that you went out and got, and you gave up a 1 and a 3. I mean, isn't it a situation where even if you don't know right now, which they do, even if you don't know right now, don't you know? I mean, even if you don't know, don't you know? That is the way that it sounds to me. It seems like if you had any question right now, well, we don't really know, I don't have an answer for you, then you're telling us the answer. Or do you believe that they're waiting? Is there something else that they believe is going to happen that they can jump in on? Do they have these huge plans, these schemes to make something happen? To me, that did speak volumes. I mean, even if you don't know right now, as he mentioned earlier today, that he had in his office a conversation with Carson Wentz earlier today. But if you're telling the public and the fan base today that you don't know, are you not actually telling them that you do? And he's playing middle of the road. That is absolutely being middle of the road. Until they're ready to make that announcement. That's where they are. Now, with the non-quarterback situation, it does appear that finally he has listened and they are going to fully address more skill position players. You know, he mentioned Michael Pittman Jr. He mentioned Jonathan Taylor. He mentioned Nyheim Hines, but I think we all know, and it's perfectly clear, that you have to go out, and I've been saying this for 4.5 years, this is nothing new. This is nothing new. I mean, and finally, it appears that they're going to try to do something more at these skill positions. Now, the other thing that was interesting that I mentioned, and this was at the side, this was not during the presser, so I don't know. I'm assuming you guys are social media enough savvy to probably gather this, but to me, this is just, again, me, my impression. To me, he feels more solid about Eric Fisher playing next year, starting at left tackle, than he is about Carson Wentz starting at quarterback. That's how it sounds to me. Now, again, I mean, you kind of know where I am with this, because to me, and I've talked about this, I believe I've been told that the decision was made, and I have questioned if that is the right decision, because I think you have to. I think you have to. And really, the overriding theme I got from today was maybe it wasn't just the tail end of the season. I mean, you go back and you look at all the close losses, you know, all the losses that, you know, had you going into the final couple of weeks of the season needing a win. But it seems to me like that they are definitely looking in places that a lot of us have been arguing they should for a number of years. And it sounded like I got more out of the side conversations or the side Q&A as he was leaving. I got more out of that than I actually did on the podium, because honestly, I fully expected the middle of the road and being non-committal. Fully expected that. I fully expected a somewhat, if not whole, change of heart as far as skill position players were concerned. I guess I didn't expect the endorsement or the near endorsement of Eric Fisher. That one kind of, because he said he was playing better. Listen, Eric Fisher in run blocking, people tell me, I'm not going to tell you I know, but people told me that run blocking was satisfactory. The one thing you can see, the pass protection at the left tackle position was not. See, I rely on others to tell me exactly that know. Like Joe Wrights would know. Like, I work on the pregame show with Joe Wrights, the former offensive lineman. I mean, he would know. He would know what's going on in the run blocking. So Joe Wrights says that Eric Fisher's run blocking was really good. So I'll just take that for what it's worth, because the guy had played that position, not at left tackle, but along the offensive line, and he would know what good run blocking is about. I wouldn't. Now, all of us, not just me, but you and me and everybody, can see when things break down. Now, oftentimes, you can blame the quarterback for it, but many times, it was very easy to blame the left tackle for it. But it seemed to me like he was certainly more in on giving Eric Fisher another year, another look, and maybe that's just out of the circumstances that they have. Because if you're going to do a deep dive and bring in competition, as he mentioned, he said he's going to bring competition in for the skill positions. If you're going to do that, are you going to have enough? I mean, really, where are you going to find another left tackle anyway? I mean, are you going to have something it seems like you're going to have to sacrifice? And I know it doesn't sound good, because you never want that to be the left tackle. But year after year, it has been the wide receiver. And year after year, we've been whining about it. And year after year, we've been accurate. And it's never good when the fan base, and it's never good when the talk show host is more accurate about that assessment than the general manager. Never good. And this has been a four-year-plus running conversation. So, if you're excited about that, be excited about that. If you're going to ask me about the offensive line, I think the offensive line is going to stay the way that it is. Now, you know, people have brought up trade possibilities. And I think Chris did say at some point during that conversation with that Q&A, you know, down at the combine that, you know, nobody is untouchable. I mean, really, everything he said shouldn't surprise anybody. But again, I got the most out of what he said presently and how he feels about the quarterback. I got the most out of finally, because if you remember after the season, he said he liked what he has. And today it was, I like what we have, but we know we have to get better. And again, at the side, talking about how he felt that Eric Fisher got better. I mean, I know we're all thinking about the quarterback and you're thinking about solutions, resolutions, if you will, to next year at the quarterback position. But, I mean, we probably should be thinking about left tackle as well. It sounds to me, it sounds to you the same way? It sounds to me like it is going to be Eric Fisher next year. So what I got most out of that conversation is, if you're not sold on your quarterback right now, then I don't know, all of a sudden, so you're going to all of a sudden get sold in the next 2 weeks? You finally understand that you need an upgrade at wide receiver. Or Michael Pittman Jr. needs help. When I say upgrade, that sounds like I'm being a jackass, and I'm not trying to be a jackass. But you have to add depth to that position. I mean, the days of, you know, T.Y. and then just throwing some guys in. Back in the Manning era, you could just throw guys in. Yeah, Peyton Manning, Ashton Doolin would have been in the Pro Bowl with Peyton Manning. You know, back in that era, you could just throw somebody in and it was going to work. Now, whoever it is. Let me introduce you to Blair White. Who? I think he's a dentist now. But he had moments for a team because they had one of the greatest of all time pulling the trigger, quarterback. You know, with this situation this past year, they did not, honestly, they didn't do enough. I will give credit where credit is due, too. And I know a lot of people, and I've been really hard on Frank as well, especially for the way that the season ended, for those games where they got off to the bad starts. But when you look at 27-7, and I know that figures and stats can be deceiving, and in this case it certainly is because we watched the play of the quarterback not be good, especially in big situations. But if you're going to look at the stats, 27-7, that doesn't look bad whatsoever. So to say that Frank entirely didn't do his job with Carson Wentz would be inaccurate. Just like it's to say that Frank shouldn't be on the hook for the way this team looked in the final 2 weeks of the season also was inaccurate. He should be. But to be fair, I think you do have to look at those numbers because, listen, we look at those numbers before we look at anything else. The outsiders, the PFFers will look at those numbers and they'll like those numbers. The problem is the PFFers, the national folks, the outsiders, they didn't watch the entirety of the season. They didn't know how this thing went down. We do. You know, they're not privy to the dialogue that we get all the time around here. They don't understand the expectations, the level, the bar in which that has been set. Hey, your negative reaction, your criticism, the criticism of this team is all 100% accurate. Because you have been told, you have been sold, and this is not what you're buying. This is not what you should expect. So, granted, there has been seemingly a change of heart in a couple of different categories. I know it's still strange, though. It's still strange to talk about, all right, so what are you doing at quarterback? I mean, you didn't think you were going to get an answer for that today. I mean, he was just trying to hustle up and get the hell away from those questions. I mean, he was probably most excited in that Q&A once the Carson Wentz questions ended. And that's what we brought to you at the beginning of the show. If you guys want to respond to that, we certainly can. Inside the Lounge via YouTube Live, you can go there, Facebook Live as well. Got a big show for you, and we'll dive into other aspects of things as well. But since that took place right before the start of the show, I thought we should bring, and at least I should bring with you, my thoughts on where I think this thing is going. I believe the quote was regarding Carson Wentz, still working through it. We'll do what's best for the team. Now, this is the question I guess I should put up as a Connecticut Water question of the day. Is this, they've made their decision and they have moved on, or they're not going to make the decision until something pops and they're hoping that something pops? Now, to me, I believe the decision is made, but there are others that believe that they are just waiting to see if something else becomes available. I guess good luck with that. That does sound like a really strong Connecticut Water question of the day. I think his other comment was, ultimately, you have to have a guy you can believe in. I'm not saying we don't believe in Wentz, working through that. Ultimately, you have to have a guy you can believe in. And if you had him for 1 year and there's nobody else out there, I mean, to me, this would be much more of an interesting question. If there was somebody else out there that made sense, to me, that would make sense. You would go, okay, I understand that. I mean, you're working an angle here. You may end up going into another direction. But to me, this is more clear to me because there's nobody else out there. Because if there's nobody else out there right now, why would you be walking away from this guy when you have nothing else? So, what, next week you're going to believe in him? A month from now you're going to believe in him? I mean, what's it going to take? How is he going to show you? How are you going to work through that without playing any games? So, if you don't know right now, don't you know? Sounds like a really good Connecticut Water question of the day. We can hit that up at 239-1070. Email address is jmv@1070thefan.com. Yeah, I don't know if we have the audio of the Eric Fisher, but he sounded like Eric Fisher is going to be your left tackle next year. Now, he mentioned Matthew Pryor as well. I think he gave a little bit of love to Chris Reed. So we'll see where they go. I think Chris Reed's a free agent, right? But it sounds like Eric Fisher is going to be your left tackle next year. Now, some of this happened right before we went on. Was there a question, have you heard yet, regarding Quentin Nelson that I missed off to the side? I am a little bit curious about that, but the Eric Fisher thing kind of stood out to me. The wide receiver thing stood out to me, and not knowing right now, to me, means that you know right now.
Yeah, Zach Kiefer had this tweeted out. He said, a deal with Quentin Nelson will get done. Quote, he's that important, Ballard said.
That important. There you go. Oh, yeah, by the way, too, regarding Paris Campbell, some of you have asked. They say they are not giving up on Paris Campbell. But at the same time, they're not looking at him as somebody they're going to count on, because you can't. And honestly, for the past couple of years, you couldn't. Unfortunately, and especially last year, you couldn't. So you cannot walk into this free agency and not be focused in on better skill position players, especially a wide receiver. And you can factor in tight end as well. You cannot come away from free agency without significantly addressing that. Now, he wasn't that upfront about it, but that's the way that it sounded to me. And that's the way that it should be. I mean, really, regardless, I don't even care who you're talking about at quarterback. I mean, we think the simpler path, and I believe that we're right, the simpler path is to do it right now and hold on to your QB for one more year. I just don't think that they're going to do that. But regardless, I don't care if you have Kyle Udermark. I don't care if you have somebody inside the lounge via YouTube Live playing quarterback. You have to do that. You have to take that thing seriously. I mean, free agent seriously for the first time. You know, granted, I know Michael Pittman Jr., Paris Campbell. I mean, I know that they've drafted for the position before. But you got to get really serious about this, no matter who the quarterback is. But if you're not sold on that right now, and regarding T.Y. Hilton, he still believes T.Y. has something left. I mean, I think we all understand, as much as T.Y. Hilton has been good here, and we have liked T.Y. Hilton here, I mean, if you can't count on Paris Campbell and you're not going to, but you have belief in him, and you're saying something similar about T.Y. Hilton, I mean, you can't count on that either, and certainly you can't pay for that. You know, and as he made it sound earlier today, that T.Y. would like to play one more year. We got that to talk about. If you like, man, Purdue's got a big one on the road in Madison later on tonight. We'll dive into that. Rob Lachman of the Boilermaker Radio Network, the play-by-play man, is going to join us from Madison coming up in the 4 o'clock hour. Jeff Rabjohns with IU's got a big one coming up tomorrow night. Jeff's going to join us in the 4 o'clock hour. Greg Rakesraw is going to join us coming up on the other side. We'll dive into some of those Q&As with the Colts postgame show host. And we got night number one of sectional play going on around the state. Jim McCann in Southern California writes this. Did I hear correctly that Carson Wentz needed some clarification on what is fair and unfair criticism? I did hear that part of it, too. I thought, honestly, Jim, I thought that Chris Ballard was talking about, he was talking about Wentz with criticism and then himself. So I think the question started about Wentz and dealing with criticism and then to take the pressure off of talking about Wentz with that in mind, he kind of put that on himself and said, well, you know, I hear criticism and I'll take it if it's fair. I'm not going to listen to it if it's unfair. Well, you know, you do end up listening to it even if it's unfair. Let me tell you this. They hear you. I mean, they hear you from this show. I mean, they're paying attention to what is certainly going on. It's just, at wide receiver, he has been hard-headed about this for a while, and it is absolutely time to get serious. Problem is, trying to get serious, you're talking about an expense that he really doesn't like, and you're talking about some of the more expensive ones, and I don't know if they're going to come at a bargain discount because they go into free agency dinged up. Three of the top four, three of the top five enter this entire thing with knee injury situations. But that's the way that it sounds to me. But, yeah, I mean, talking about criticism that's fair or unfair. And it seemed like to me that the GM was just kind of trying to shoulder that. Rocking that V-neck sweater. My man looked like he was working on his lats right before he got in there, too. He gave Bowen a shout for his wide receiver question, and he gave Mike Wells a shout for asking a biting question. Hey, believe me, any question, and all due respect to Mike there, good for Mike, any question regarding Carson Wentz in this time, because they don't want to answer it. Now, you're going to be interesting to see how Frank handles it coming up at 4. I don't know. Frank is going to say nothing about a lot. Just get ready for that. I mean, it's going to take some significant pull. If you want to talk about it, and I know that Chris had mentioned this too. Chris had mentioned that he and Frank and Mr. Irsay, as he put it, will make these decisions coming up as far as how this team is going to look. Not specific to the quarterback situation, but he just said in general terms, they're going to make decisions. Here's how I view it. The decision with the owner is not to have the quarterback return, and that's the way that it has been. I kind of wonder if Ballard a little bit thinks how we think of, hey, I don't like what else is out there. Maybe we should stay with this. I think that he's on the fence, and I think Frank obviously would want to bring him back. I think that's how it is, and I think that's how we know where this decision is going to go. JMV, it's just a guess. I think Ballard is testing Wentz to see if he takes any accountability for what happened. Will go a long way to whether or not to bring him back. I don't know if I would buy that because, again, the decision's been made. I think it's more of a why than it is trying to save this. It's just me, though. It's me. Again, I mean, if you don't know right now, so you go all the way back to Luck. This is like the point in time, this and the next couple of weeks, this is when it would have been okay for Andrew Luck to retire. I mean, everybody would have still probably been bent because he's so young. This is when it was okay. After this month is when you are all in, when all of your chips are on the table. I know it's just the first day of this particular month, but to really try to suggest that you don't know right now. And again, if there was more out there to go after, if there was more out there to go get that seemed reasonable to everybody, I think you can make that statement and make it believable. But given what there is to go after right now, I don't know how that statement's believable. All right, quick break, and we'll come back with that. Pacers lose last night to the Orlando Magic. They are off tonight. They're back in Orlando. That is coming up on Wednesday. SWW said the Colts are running it back with Wentz. Irsay's all chips in. Proclamation is going to look really bad. Yeah, they seem like that they're kind of painted into a corner here a little bit. That's the other thing, too, and you bring up a great point. I mean, when Jim says the chips are all in, but you don't know. You don't know about your quarterback on March 1, and that's what you want everybody to believe? Rob Blackman, Jeff Rabjohns, Greg Rakestraw is going to join us coming on the other side. We'll clarify that, get your calls, and a lot more. Facebook Live, YouTube Live, the stream, the app, 93.5, 107.5 The Fan.
Hey guys, it's the new year. Are you still struggling with erectile dysfunction? I've yet to meet anyone that enjoys timing those intimate moments around a pill. Well, now you don't have to. The advanced wave technology at Pine Grove Medical Clinic has been shown by Cambridge University and the Cleveland Clinic to restore and even regrow blood vessels. It can improve circulation and eliminate erectile dysfunction. No pills and no side effects. If you're ready to put a stop to your ED, call us in the next 2 minutes and you'll receive a consultation, assessment, and blood flow ultrasound free, plus a special gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. You're going to love that. Trust me. This is a $600 value, free to callers now. 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, get rid of your ED and get that spark back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. 317-552-1111.
Feeling the pinch of higher prices?
Golden Oak Lending can save you money with their low 2.25% rate.
James Hawkins here, president of Golden Oak. Offset high prices with lower monthly payments or turn your home equity into cash.
Lock in this low rate while you can. Call 317-706-GOLD today.
Golden Oak Lending cured my blues.
NMLS 114937. 2.25% fixed. 3.336% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Sometimes a change of seasons calls for a change of scenery. Well, in St. Pete, Clearwater, Florida, you can trade in the heat of a blasting furnace for the healing warmth of the sun. You can trade in gray skies for a beautiful calming blue. You can trade in shoveling sidewalks for biking the beach walk promenade. And you can trade in white snow for 35 miles of pristine white sand. Sounds like you found a winter getaway to immerse all your senses. Start planning your beach escape at visitstpeteclearwater.com.
At Uline, they know going the extra mile takes hard work. For companies pushing to go further, Uline will go the distance with you. 24/7, they answer the phone to get you the shipping and industrial supplies you need. Business can move fast. Unexpected large orders, adverse weather, new safety guidelines, and changing economic trends. Uline works hard keeping 38,000 items ready to ship, minimizing detours on your way to the extra mile. Visit uline.com.
Oh, while we're in lawn and garden, I was thinking I should pick up one of those little things for watering my plants.
A hose?
No, the things that look like teapots, but for plants, you know, you tip it over and it goes...
You're good at describing words you've forgotten.
Like those things that give the plants a shower, you know, that you fill up.
A watering can?
Yes, a watering can. I knew that.
We're good at your insurance. Find an Indiana Farm Bureau insurance agent online, over the phone, or in person, and stop. Knocking on wood.
Hoops are happening, and college basketball's biggest stage is right around the corner over on PropSwap. Every season, prop swappers make thousands of dollars by simply buying and selling college basketball teams. Well, now is the time to find those Cinderellas where the odds are still high. So get to your local sportsbook, buy a handful of tickets, and list them on PropSwap. Remember, only one team needs to make a run, and that ticket will pay for the rest. You can buy and sell tickets over on PropSwap at any point during a game, tournament, season. Dark horses happen every year, so download the free PropSwap app today. Remember, PropSwap is where America buys and sells sports bets. If you're looking for better odds than what your sportsbook is offering, look no further. PropSwap is your answer. There's never been a better time to join. Use promo code FREE100 to receive 100% deposit bonus up to $100. To find the best odds, join the real sports bettors and download the free PropSwap app today.
It's Super Cash time at Old Navy. Right now, redeem your $10 in Super Cash and save $10 on every $25 purchase. Use it on everything. Run to Old Navy or OldNavy.com today. Valid 226 to 36. Excludes gift cards and clearance. See OldNavy.com/SuperCash for more details.
This ad for Helzberg Diamonds has been specifically written for those who'd rather think about hockey than engagement rings. You're at a game and your team scores the winning goal just as time runs out. Now, if that game is your proposal and you're running out of time to find the perfect engagement ring, Helzberg Diamonds is your winning shot. Our combination of quality diamonds, wide selection, and a price match guarantee means you can be confident in your Helzberg Diamonds engagement ring buzzer beater. Visit your local Helzberg store and ask about our amazing financing options or check us out at Helzberg.com.
The Ride with JMV.
Say, man, you got a joint?
No, not on me, man.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Jeff Remjohn's top of the hour. Rob Blackman, Boilermaker Radio Network, here to jump in here in the 4 o'clock hour, too. What time's Frank Reich? 4 o'clock? Down at the Combine, Chris Ballard a little bit earlier. I will say this, in response to that tweet from a little bit earlier, you know, talking about, you know, accountability and he doesn't know right now, all that. I mean, listen, there's not a lot you're going to be able to say. You just read between the lines on it. If you were good with it and you were moving forward with it, you would say that. If you were either going to try to hopefully have a market to trade him, or ultimately release him because there is no market, you say what was said today. Andy Moore, Automotive Group Hotline. Our friend Greg Rakestraw joins us. You happened to listen to Chris Ballard earlier today, Greg. Were you down there?
I did not have a chance to listen to him because I generally treat the combine the way that you do. If I can avoid it, I'm all for it, despite the fact I love the fact that it's here and recognize the economic impact that it has. So I have been following the Twitter play-by-play just like you have been.
All right. So follow the play-by-play. And I had said, if you don't know about your quarterback now, you do know about your quarterback now. What do you think?
The fact is, and again, you described it very well. You're trying not to hang the guy out to dry because, again, you're trying to create trade value as well as not embarrass the guy that was your starting quarterback last year. But to me, the what has been said and not said over the course of the last 2 months kind of tells me everything that I need to know. So at this point, I would be very surprised if Carson Wentz is on this roster a month from now. Even if the quarterback market is not a great one, which given the assets or lack thereof, the Colts have been able to trade for one, just what was not said in terms of kind of endorsing him in early January, I don't think anything has changed now in the first day of March. So I think the Colts are going to go in a different direction.
Colts postgame show host and more, Greg Rakestraw, is on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. And it seemed like that Chris moved off of I like what we have here right now regarding the wide receivers. So I would expect a much more deeper dive in free agency, which honestly has been necessary for a while. You agree?
I would agree with that as well. And again, it is also a point of kind of where you have built this team and where you have invested in this team in terms of draft capital. And I'm not trying to say that offensive line play was perfect end of the year. It's not. But you generally have an idea who your five offensive line starters are going to be this year. You can still question exactly what the ceiling is going to be for guys like Kwity Paye and Dio Odangbo. But you invested your first two draft picks in offensive linemen last year. You've got Buckner, you've got Grover Stewart. You kind of have an idea what your defensive line is going to look like. At this point, there's only kind of so many holes that, in theory, you've got to fill. Wide receiver would be one of them. Tight end is likely going to be another of them. So I think this year in free agency and the draft, although again without a first round pick, you're kind of trying to spackle the places you haven't paid as much attention to. And that would be wide receiver and tight end for this football team.
All right. Well, how about a little spackle job at left tackle, too? Because this was not a part of the presser, but off to the side, as they normally do, he was surrounded by media, and they got to talking about the offensive line. And to both Kyle and I, it sounded like that he's going to take another swing with Eric Fisher at left tackle this year. What do you think?
Yeah, and again, that kind of falls under the category of kind of the reasoning behind potentially going with Wentz for a second year is because there's not that many other great options out there. Again, it goes back to it's why I thought last year was the chance to address left tackle in the first round because there were so many tackles available in the first round. That's seemingly the case every year. But again, because knowing you've invested heavily or about to invest heavily at the time in Braden Smith, which they did, you'd already invested heavily in Ryan Kelly. The general thought is you're going to invest heavily in Quentin Nelson. You had to have somebody playing on a rookie deal, and Chris Ballard did not like kind of the crop of tackles seemingly in the first or second round a year ago because he went away from those guys, and he went with more defensive tackle or defensive end. And if you don't have that first-round pick, which they don't, it kind of means that the best option might be to see, hey, give Eric Fisher another year removed from that Achilles injury and see if you can get something better out of him in year number two than you did in year number one.
So Greg Rakestraw with us via the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. So we covered most of that. Frank Reich is going to meet with the media coming up here at the top of the hour. But I also have you on here because I want to get to a couple of college things and then the high school basketball. Sectional first round action around the state is underway officially later on tonight. But I want to start with Purdue and Wisconsin. What we didn't like about Purdue at Michigan State on Saturday, is this thing correctable against the Wisconsin team that has been surprisingly more than solid throughout the portion of this Big Ten campaign?
I am to the point where I almost don't care about the next two games or the Big Ten tournament. I'm just ready to hit the fast forward button and get to the NCAA tournament. And honestly, I felt that way for a while. Just because this is clearly a team that's got some flaws. They are a team that is a hard team to match up with, because hardly anybody has the speed and versatility of a Jaden Ivey. Nobody has the size of Zach Edey. Travion Williams is his own unique package. This can be a streaky team from three-point range. but it's not your prototypical Purdue team in terms of the ability to guard somebody or shut somebody down. I think the best thing that can happen for Purdue is to stop playing Big Ten teams, which in theory you're going to do for the first couple of rounds, if not three, of the NCAA tournament. And given the fact we've talked about, hey, we've seen Purdue win Big Ten championships, we've seen Purdue win conference tournament championships, what we haven't done is see Purdue make a run to the Final Four or compete for a national championship in the last 40 to 42 years. That's really what this is all about. So if they beat Wisconsin, great. And if they lose to them, well, it probably cost them a seed line. And you can argue that what it would do is actually cost them potentially more of a chance to play a first-round game or two. And I haven't broken down in terms of protected seedings and who was going kind of to what regional at this point. You could say maybe you lose the advantage of having a chance to play in Indianapolis. But then again, you had a chance to play in Indianapolis for the entire tournament last year and couldn't win your first-round game. So we're almost kind of the point now where I'm like, you know what? Let's just get to the tournament. Let's see how Purdue matches up. Because, again, I think Purdue is going to be a very difficult team to match up with for most teams in the NCAA tournament.
All right, Greg, IU Rutgers coming up tomorrow night in Bloomington. Thoughts?
They win, they're in. I don't think they're a great team. But every question we asked about Indiana this season was, could you make the NCAA tournament? For a while, we talked about, hey, could they be a Sweet 16 team? I don't think that's going to happen. But I do think that by avoiding embarrassing losses at home to Maryland and at Minnesota, and now if you can beat Rutgers, that's likely a team that you are, not because you're in the same conference, but just because of where kind of both teams are from the net and the seed lines and projections, et cetera, that is a team you can frankly take a tournament bid from. I almost think the Purdue game is kind of house money for this Indiana basketball team. If you can win in Mackey, great. Your fate is sealed. You're going to be an NCAA tournament team. But I also think that Mike Woodson's team can accomplish that goal simply by beating Rutgers tomorrow night at Assembly Hall.
All right, so they beat Rutgers tomorrow night, and let's just say they get boat raced by the Boilermakers and then lose in unspectacular fashion in their first outing in the Big Ten Conference Tournament. That wouldn't have a bearing?
Now you're sweating it out. Now you are flop sweating during the NCAA selection show on March 13th. So yes, again, it's almost as much about avoiding a bad loss as it is getting a great win. Great wins certainly help. As long as you can avoid the bad loss, if you're the Hoosiers, I think you're okay.
So Greg Rakestraw with us. Final thing, got sectional play firing up around the state of Indiana later on tonight. The CJ Gunn situation is pretty interesting.
It is, and that's the game that I've got.
Nice.
So I will have Lawrence North and Attucks at 6 o'clock tonight. In fact, I am talking to you from the parking lot at North Central High School because we have an early start here this evening. So I had the first LN Attucks game, and that game was played without Jack Kiefer or Omar Cooper because of both getting ejected from the previous game. At that point, was a loss to Tinley back on December the 28th. LN beat Attucks that night with C.J. Gunn, his second game of the season at the time, by a score of 60-39. The Attucks is not as good as they have been in recent years. Attucks can beat LN without C.J. Gunn. However, got to remember that LN opened the season. I think the first seven games of the year, LN did not have C.J. Gunn. He missed time, missed almost all of December because of a broken toe. So this group kind of knows how to play without C.J. Gunn. The problem that LN has without Gunn in the lineup is not finding guys that can score the basketball. They've got good pieces that can do that. This may be the smallest team that Jack Kiefer has had in 30 or 40 years. Gunn's their only player really over 6'3 or 6'4 that sees minutes. And seemingly LN always has a big. That is not the case this year. There's a young man named Desmond Briscoe that plays for Crispus Attucks, 6'7 freshman, who's averaging 10.5 rebounds a game. So it's more of a depth issue, more of a size issue for LN tonight. I still think they can get the job done, but it's not a sure thing that LN advances without C.J. Gunn out of night number one.
The two technicals, you may not know, but how did they come about?
I believe they were both of the taunting variety, I believe, was the call behind that. So,
oh, man.
Yep.
Yeah, boy. Well, yeah, you're going to have your teammates pick you up coming up later on tonight. That sounds like a pretty, if you were going to ask for games to do, that's a pretty solid one right there. Well done.
Well, this is the fourth consecutive year that I will end up doing every game from, you can't give a location because they rotate this sectional around so much. But again, for the third year, the combination of teams are Addicts, Tech, LCLN, Warren, Cathedral, and North Central. It is a wonderful group of teams. Six of the seven teams come in with 13 wins or more. We have the city champ. We have the county champ. You've got, what, four, five, six teams that have a Division I recruit that are in this sectional. This sectional's so good every year. And looking to spend in four of my next five nights about all of 10 minutes from my house here at North Central High School.
It's Greg Rakestraw with us via the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. We are getting busy. I love it because I know the women's tournament is in town now. You get the combine at the same time, but I love it when they start hanging all the team banners around the downtown. Yep. That's a hell of a time of year always here.
By the way, I want to give a quick shout out because I don't think it's going to go well, but I want to recognize my guys at IUPUI. They are playing a conference tournament game tonight, John, with five players. They are on the road at Oakland. There will be zero bench minutes or points for IUPUI today. The Iron Five will be Mike DePersia, Nathan McClure, Boston Stanton III, Chukes Isatua, and B.J. Maxwell. The victory for those guys is playing tonight. I doubt they will fare well against Oakland University, but those guys have been through a lot this year, and they have carried themselves with dignity and class every step of the way. And I hope for good things tonight, but if it doesn't go well, good on those guys for the effort they put in all season long.
When is the last time a team played with five?
I know that I can think of like a couple of occasions when you would have guys that teams that finished with like say three or four on the floor. I know Arkansas had a situation like that a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
I know maybe you were in school at the time when Indiana State got in a bench-clearing brawl with Wichita State and finished the game with four guys. Had to play a good chunk of that game with four. I can think of a case where I'm not sure if it was they played with five or they only played five. I know that IU Northwest a handful of years ago went to Eastern Kentucky and got a win. I think maybe only played their starting five the entire game. So,
but nobody's ever just had five, and that's it.
I'm sure it's happened, but not one that I can think of off the top of my head.
We got to get some folks over at IUPUI to run some data there, because this is, and I know that more than likely this is going to end badly, but I can't think of any times when something like this has happened. Maybe I'm just missing it right now, but I couldn't come up with anything.
No, and when, as soon as the kid that got hurt was Bakari Lestrap on Saturday, because I had the game on Saturday afternoon, and when he got up, I said, you know, I said IUPUI has somehow managed to play for 4 weeks with six guys, and those six have not found out of a game. Those six have stayed remotely healthy. You knew it was a matter of time before that caught up with them, and it finally happened 3 minutes into the game on Saturday afternoon.
Have yourself one hell of a call and a weekend, too. I know you're going to be incredibly busy, and we'll have a lot to talk about coming up next week as well. Next Tuesday is going to be interesting. There's no doubt about that. But I appreciate you more than you know.
You got it, buddy. Thank you.
Greg Rakestraw on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. I think C.J. Gunn's dad was at a remote of ours. I think it was if Gary Harris Sr.'s out there, I think that we were all at Joe's Grill up in Fishers back in the fall, I believe. So I met them up there, and he is not going to be playing coming up later on tonight, which adds a great deal of intrigue, no doubt about that. So it is officially underway. Top of the hour, Jeff Rabjohn's Rob Blackman's also going to slide in there in that first segment, the 4 o'clock hour. We got more for you from the Chris Ballard presser earlier today. If you missed it, not a lot was said, but maybe a little bit more clarity for you in how it was framed up. We'll get to that your calls, of which I owe you, coming up as well. Pace is a loser last night, and a big one in Madison for the Boilermakers against Wisconsin coming up later on tonight. Quick break, and we're back. I want to make sure. Yep, it was. I just got it. There's Gary Harris Sr. It was at Joe's Grill up in Fishers with CJ Gunn's dad. That was back in, I believe, October, somewhere in that neighborhood. Quick break, and we shall return. 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
We upgraded. What do we upgrade? Our live streams. Find us at 107.5 The Fan on YouTube to watch, conversate, participate, and hang out with us in the new Hubler Studio today.
Are you feeling the pinch of higher prices?
Costs may be rising, but with Golden Oak Lending's 2.25% fixed rate, you can lower your mortgage payments.
James Hawkins here, president of Golden Oak. You can offset today's high prices by using the low interest equity in your home to pay off credit cards, make home improvements, or simply put cold hard cash back in your pocket.
It only takes a few minutes to see if you can save hundreds with this low 2.25% rate.
So what are you waiting for? Lock in our low rate while you still can. Start saving money and skip your first two mortgage payments.
Call your local loan officers at 317-706-GOLD today and pay nothing out of pocket.
That's right. If we can't close your loan, the appraisal is no charge.
Golden Oak Lending, cured my blues.
NMLS 114937. 2.25% fixed, 3.336% APR, FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Daughtry. Heavy is the crowd. The Dearly Beloved Tour. The multi-platinum, multi-award winner returns. This Saturday night at 7, Marat Theater at Old National Center. Special guests, Tremonti and Lyle. Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com or OldNationalCenter.com. The Dearly Beloved Tour.
JMV here for Mark Deedle Realty, 317-755-4232. That's 317-755-4232. Online, markdeedle.com. That's markdeetel.com today. The absolute best in what he does, no matter what you're thinking about doing as you're getting into the housing market. In fact, Kevin and Gwen from Bargersville say this about Mark: excited about moving to our new home, but skeptical about getting the price we needed quickly. Enter Mark Deedle. He had multiple offers in 2 days, and things worked out fantastically. Those are the testimonials you're going to get for the absolute best, and that is Mark Deedle. In fact, his system guarantees multiple offers in 3 days for full market value, or he will list it for free. That's Mark Deedle Realty, 317-755-4232. 317-755-4232. Mark Deedle online, markdeedle.com. That's Mark DIETEL.com today.
We buy any car. We buy any car. We buy any car. Any.
Trading in or selling your car, truck, or SUV? WeBuyAnyCar.com takes the hassle out of selling in just 3 easy steps. 1. Get your free online valuation. 2. Drive to your local car buying center. And 3. Walk out with your check in as little as 30 minutes. So don't wait. Get your free online valuation now at WeBuyAnyCar.com.
Find out how much your car's worth at WeBuyAnyCar.com.
Hey, Johnny for Aurora Sleep Clinic. I slept like crap. Honestly, I did because I snored. And I mean like a freight train. Couldn't do anything about it. And I talked about it here. Brian Evans, Dr. Steve Green, of course, a couple of former IU basketballers heard me talk about it. And they said, hey, come to the Aurora Sleep Clinic. We're going to set you up with this simple and affordable and easy to use mouthpiece. You wear it at night, and it's going to fix your snoring situation. You know what? It did. I am so happy that I went there. If you struggle with snoring or you know somebody that does, let's do something about it. StopYourSnoreNow.com. That's StopYourSnoreNow.com to get that consultation and get on the road to incredible bed rest finally with Aurora Sleep Clinic. StopYourSnoreNow.com.
It's Super Cash time at Old Navy. Right now, redeem your $10 in Super Cash and save $10 on every $25 purchase. Use it on everything. Run to Old Navy or OldNavy.com today. Valid 226 to 36. Excludes gift cards and clearance. See OldNavy.com/SuperCash for more details.
Mortgage interest rates have started to rise, but I'm still locking my clients in near historic lows. Visit thehomeloanexpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
Join me tomorrow, Chris Ballard, the general manager of the Colts, going to be sitting right in here with me for his annual visit. It is happening at 1 o'clock. You don't want to miss it. Join me tomorrow, noon to 3.
The Ride with JMV.
Just an average guy with exceptional hair.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. Something just like
this. I battled a little bit earlier. I met with the media talking about that. Frank Wright coming up here at the top of the hour. Down at the NFL Combine. Jeff writes this, JMV at 1070thefan.com. Would you rather have Wentz back here for another mediocre season just outside the playoff picture, or Wentz goes elsewhere and is rejuvenated into a top 10 quarterback? Listen, I don't care what happens, but there's been so much conversation about the greatness over there and winning divisions and going into the postseason and hosting a home playoff game. I am sick of anything less, and you should be too. You should be too. I mean, how great the general manager is and how great and the depth, yeah. You need to be tired of it too. So whatever. You're going to be held accountable for winning and doing these things that you've talked about. I can't see it any other way. Hey, Garen, get in here before the top of the hour really quick. Give me the smartest Boilermaker fan on the face of the earth about tonight's matchup of Madison. Go.
I think this is the biggest Big Ten for the game for them in at least 10 years. Because not only this is for the conference title, but this is for the right to play in Chicago, likely as a 2 seed. And I hope they're less sloppy than they were Saturday. And I hope they make more than 1 3-pointer, because if they're not, they're going to beat.
Yes, no doubt about that. I just, I don't want to see him end up completely playing Wisconsin's game, because I hate Wisconsin's game, even though it's successful. But well, that's what I don't want to see.
Over the years, they've had zero problems going up to
Madison,
right. So they should be able to do it tonight. But it's just that you got to be able to score the ball from the outside, and they didn't do that the last game, and it just kills me what a lost opportunity that was. But that just puts all that more importance on this evening.
Have you expected more out of this team that you haven't seen to this point of the season? Is there any disappointment whatsoever with you?
Yes, in the respect that. The high point felt like the Illinois game. That was 6 wins in a row, and it really felt like they were taking off, and it's just kind of stayed there. And as positive as I typically am on things, right now it just feels like something's missing, and I have this giant fear that there's going to be another 12-turnover game where they only hit one or two threes, and that's going to be the one and done. And that's even though it was just a Big Ten loss, that's what that felt like to me the other night. Was it felt like a game that they could have had, they didn't. And sure, it's only maybe for the Big Ten title, but they have to figure that out to be able to advance the tournament and to get to that ultimate prize of New Orleans.
I agree with you right there. He is the most knowledgeable Boilermaker fan of the face of the earth. He is our friend, Garen. Brother, enjoy the game tonight.
I'll be watching. You will too. See you, man.
I will be. Garen, thank you. Quick break and we'll come back. Rob Blackman, Jeff Rabjohns, all coming up this hour. 93.5 107.5 The Fan.
Hi, this is Ted Bishop, PGA General Manager at the Legends Golf Club in Franklin. This year, we are celebrating our 30th anniversary of being in business, and I want to personally invite you to become a member at our course, which was selected as the 2021 Indiana Golf Course of the Year. We are offering a limited number of 2-year Monday through Friday memberships starting at $199 a year. Yep, you heard it right, only $199 a year, and you can upgrade to a 7-day membership for only $50 per year more. If you ride, you just pay for the golf cart, and if you walk, there's no additional charge. These memberships will expire on December 31 of 2023. Legends has 27 Fazio Design Championship holes. Our regular players will tell you that we are known for great playing conditions and a friendly staff. Join the Legends Golf Club today. Don't delay, because limited spots are available. Call 317-736-8186 or buy online at thelegendsgolfclub.com. And I'll see you on the first tee.
You're working hard to build wealth for the future, but along the way, you'll need to help protect it from risk and make sure it can last through retirement. Join us today at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern for a brand new virtual event, 3 strategies to help preserve and protect your wealth. You can register for free at planefe.com. Discover steps you can take today to help secure a better tomorrow. At our new virtual event, 3 strategies to help preserve and protect your wealth, you'll learn what to do if you own too much of one stock, how to choose which retirement accounts to take withdrawals from, and more. Our advice comes from more than 35 years of experience managing wealth in different market environments. Join us for a special virtual event, 3 strategies to help preserve and protect your wealth, today at 3 p.m. or 8 p.m. Eastern. Register for free at planefe.com. That's planefe.com. Edelman Financial Engines. From here forward.
Hey, Johnny, for Race Trash Service. Race Trash Service with jobs right now. If you have a commercial driver's license, listen up. I'm talking about great pay, terrific benefits, and a fantastic working environment. And in fact, a working environment that's been around and family operated since the 1960s. Awesome. So if you're a driver, jump on this right now, racetrash.com, and apply today. Or if you're a non-driver, again, a great company. They have non-driving opportunities for you right now at Race Trash Service. Apply today, racetrash.com.
When it comes to working at Geico, our best advocates are our employees, like Justina. But since she is so focused on growing her career, we hired an actor to read her story.
At Geico, I receive support from those above me. If you want to move up, you really have that relationship and encouragement.
As a full-time employee, she can even get paid training and tuition reimbursement. Yep, there's no stopping her now. She's even taking over book club.
Ready to start your career, Indy? We're hiring claim sales and service agents. Apply online today at geico.job/indy.
Prescription products require an online physician consultation and are only available if the physician determines a prescription is appropriate. Subscription required. See website for full details and important safety information.
When you lose your hair, you lose more than just hair. You lose your confidence. But that doesn't have to happen. Today, there are proven medical solutions to stop hair loss, and in some cases, regrow what you've lost. And now you can get them online at forhims.com, including the very latest treatment, topical finasteride and minoxidil spray. It combines 2 proven hair loss treatments in the only hair loss spray of its kind, and only forhims.com has it. No more pills, no more messy, time-consuming applications. Topical finasteride and minoxidil spray is only available by prescription, but at forhims.com, you can connect with a medical provider online who will, if appropriate, prescribe this new spray and ship it to your home. It's that easy. Get the old hair back. Get the old you back at forhims.com. For a free online consultation, go to forhims.com/care. Regrow your hair in 3 to 6 months at forhims.com/care. forhims.com/care.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
The Pacers close out their series with the Magic in Orlando tomorrow evening at 6:30 on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
The Ride with JMV.
Just when I think you couldn't possibly be any dumber, you go and do something like this and totally redeem yourself.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Greg Rakestraw, podcast 107.5. The Fan a little bit earlier. Chris Ballard met with the media earlier today. We'll go over that again with you regarding the quarterback position, where you said they simply did not know right now. So we'll question that. Going on a deeper dive at the wide receiver, the skill positions, which I think everybody would dig, and I have for the past 4.5 years, and whether or not you buy that it sounds like Eric Fisher is going to be your left tackle coming up this year, if you buy that or not. That and more with you coming up on the other side. Rob Blackman of the Boilermaker Radio Network also is coming up. I have America tickets for you as well. And by the way, Frank Reich is down at the Combine right now, meeting in front of the media regarding Carson Wentz. Ongoing process. Everybody gets evaluated. Is that it? That's it. Again, what else is he going to say? So basically the same thing that Chris said. Ongoing process. Everybody gets evaluated. Andy Moore, Automotive Group Hotline. Let's evaluate the knowledge on this IU basketball team and where it's going with our good friend from Pigs. It's Jeff Rabjohns, again via the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. By the way, as far as the Ballard stuff, mm-hmm. aren't we all getting evaluated day to day in life? I mean, I don't understand why executives sometimes come out and say the players are being evaluated. Aren't you always evaluating all your players?
Yeah, I think because they don't want to. They don't want to tell you exactly what's going on. So
it just seems like it's one of those generic lines
it
that
is.
They throw out,
yeah.
And it basically says we either don't know, haven't made a decision,
exactly.
Or we just ain't going to say anything. It's a great way to talk, but
yeah.
Say nothing.
I'm assuming sitting right here on the first day of March, if you don't know that your quarterback is and should be the quarterback after what you did to bring him here after year number one, then I would guess you probably know. So
that seems reasonable.
It does seem very reasonable. All right, how reasonable is this? A win and you're in scenario tomorrow night against Rutgers in Bloomington for IU.
It's certainly really close. It's certainly really close to that, especially when, you know, you look at the metrics and everything. You know, Indiana's sitting there at 43rd in the net rankings. They have 3 quad one wins already, 6 quad one and two wins. And they have 0 losses in quad 3 and 4, and that's kind of notable because sometimes bad losses take a team out of the NCAA tournament as much as, or maybe even more, than good wins get you into the NCAA tournament. So if Indiana can win against Rutgers, I think that'll help. You know, Rutgers' metrics aren't great because they had a bad start to the season, you know, with losses to like UMass and Lafayette and people like that. But the selection committee actually watches games. And Rutgers has beaten Wisconsin, Purdue, Illinois, Michigan, Michigan State, and Ohio State. Now, Rutgers has been playing good basketball for most of the last 6-7 weeks, somewhere in that ballpark. So it actually would be beating a good team, and I think that would get consideration. You know, you look at most bracketology, they either have IU in the regular field or in the first four. So I think one more win, it would be really, really, really close. But if they win that game, it definitely puts them in a situation where regardless of what happens at Purdue, and I really don't think IU's got a great chance at Purdue, obviously. I think that's pretty – I don't think – you don't need analytics to figure that out. But if they beat Rutgers, then they go in the Big Ten tournament knowing that without question – all they need is one win in the Big Ten tournament, then they're squarely in the NCAA tournament.
So Jeff Rabjohns of Pigs.com with us via the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. Are they able to, for a stretch run here, bottle what we have seen from Xavier Johnson recently? Because that does seem, with this group, with the competition they've had, that seems such a huge difference, and maybe the most noted difference on this team between winning and losing or hanging in games or winning games that they should. Agree?
Absolutely. The biggest determinant over the last 7 games, whether IU wins or losses, how Xavier Johnson plays. You know, during Indiana's 5-game losing skid, he shot just 28%. 13 for 46 from the floor, was only 2 for 14 from 3. And I used past two wins, he shot 61% from the floor, including 7 for 9 from 3. So he has been the biggest difference between poor play when IU loses and very good play when IU wins. So, yeah, he's a big factor. And I think part of it is he's an emotional guy. He openly admits he's an emotional guy. And when he can harness his emotions, when he can really understand, okay, what are we trying to get this play, this 4-minute stretch, this half, this game? And when he stays inside of what he's supposed to do, attacks when it's there but doesn't get reckless, then he's really helpful. When he sort of gets lost in what you're trying to do, maybe forgets, maybe just gets too emotional, like second half of Wisconsin when IU lost, you know, and he just wanted to prove he could drive and score against the Wisconsin Bigs, goes 1 for 11, he can take IU out of games. So, yeah, I think going down the stretch, Xavier Johnson's the biggest constant. You know, Trace is still producing around 14-8, you know, per game. I know some fans are saying, oh, man, you know, he's preseason All-American. I want more from him. That's understandable, but I think sometimes people forget he's actually been really impactful for an entire season. Race Thompson's been solid, but starting to get a little more from guys like Jordan Geronimo, you know, who had 10 points at Minnesota. Get a little more from Tamar Bates, a little more from Miller Kopp. You know, Miller Kopp had a 20-point game at Syracuse November 30th, didn't score in double figures again until Minnesota. So Indiana's starting to get a little more from the other players, but the biggest singular factor
is how Xavier Johnson plays, because he can help IU win a game, and he can take IU out of a game.
You'd mentioned the negative energy versus the positive energy, and we saw him unleash that positive energy and that drive and dunk against Maryland. And I do think moments like that where he creates a noted positive helps a little bit of that pressure release that he does. He does have some pent-up pressure, angst, frustration in his game, does he not?
Yeah. He does play with an edge. He is an emotional player. And obviously you need some degree of emotion to go out there. You know, you can't go out there like a robot. But when his emotion leads to positive energy, it's absolutely a positive factor for Indiana. And when he slips into kind of what you could probably call maybe frustration mode and makes some of those plays you look at and go, what was that? You know, or, you know, he gets baited into certain things, you know, gets baited into the long twos or things like that. Then, yeah, it's a negative situation as far as energy for Indiana. And then it's a negative situation as far as plays being produced. You know, long twos that are bad, that you're not going to make a high percentage of, you know, they're not like turnovers, but they're close. Because, you know, you're not going to make them to high percentage. You're only going for 2 points instead of three. They're just not very good shots in the game of basketball. But, yeah, when he brings the positive energy, it's certainly a big plus for Indiana.
Hey, Jeff Redjohns of Pigs.com is on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline. A couple of other things I wanted to ask. I mean, to me, I always find it very hard to figure out in what year we're in and who's in their final year and who's not in their final year. And given the fact that it's senior night in Bloomington tonight, who is absolutely in their final year and who's going to take advantage of that extra COVID year offer in Bloomington?
Yeah, that's going to be the offseason story for pretty much every team, because every player currently in college basketball who was in college basketball last year has an additional year. They can take it if they want. And also, to be fair, if their teams want them to take it, you know, the coaches get to make decisions too. And this year you could go over the 13 player scholarship limit to keep your own players. Next year you have to be at 13 no matter what, whether that's allowing players currently on your team with an extra year to stay, incoming recruits, incoming transfers, whatever, you have to be at 13 scholarship players next year. So there's going to be decisions made, again, from players and from coaches. Right now, Indiana's got three incoming players, so three guys are going to have to go, at least three. And that's three signed high school players before we even talk about potential transfer portal additions or what have you. You know, Race Thompson and Parker Stewart are speaking tomorrow night for senior night. Indiana has emphasized to me repeatedly, Abby, don't assume just because somebody's speaking, they're automatically leaving. Don't assume just because somebody's not speaking, they're automatically returning. So who's going to stay? Who's going to go? I think we're going to see conversations, you know, after the season ends between players and coaches. And coaches are going to figure out who wants to come back and who do they want back. I know with some programs, there's some coaches out there who are like, hey man, you know, we had a bad year. You know, I don't want a whole bunch of bad players back. You know, we need to go get different dudes. So we'll see what happens. But right now, I don't think we know for sure who's definitely back or who's not. Rob Phinisee did say today, that he's leaving it open. But again, I think that's going to be that's going to be the big decision for college coaches. Those are going to be the postseason sit downs. Instead of just talking about the normal thing, okay, you know, you were a sophomore, here's what we want you to improve on going into your junior year, whatever. I think there's going to be a lot more stay or go conversations than we've ever seen before, because all these guys have the extra year due to COVID, and the players who haven't transferred, they can transfer and play immediately.
I do want to ask you this, and you may not know this because, I mean, hell, it's not the end of the season just yet, and I don't even know if you guys have asked about this, but how would you, even if you don't know, how would you expect they feel about their usage in year one of the transfer portal?
You mean Indiana?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they went out, obviously Parker Stewart transferred, you know, mid-season last year.
Right.
You know, he was there on the team. But as far as like portal players, I guess you could say that they brought in, you know, with Miller Kopp there at forward and Michael Doerr at center, you know, they've gotten solid contributions. But they haven't been like, major big time impact players. Most of the impact players for Indiana, outside of Xavier Johnson, who obviously was, you know, the biggest pickup for them, they needed a point guard who could get downhill. That's what they looked for. That's what they went out and got. He's had the most impact. But if you look around college basketball, most of the transfer portal players are role players. Some maybe, you know, a little bigger role, but there's only, you know, I don't know, 5, 10, maybe 12 guys out there really impactful. You know, I like Walker Kessler down there at Auburn, phenomenal player. He's on the Naismith Defensive Player of the Year semifinal list, along with Oscar Tshiebwe at Kentucky, who transferred from West Virginia. So there are some guys like that. But most of the players who entered the portal and did end up transferring are either role players or, this is probably only 10, 15% of them, players who dropped down a level so they could really play. You know, drop down, you know, they were maybe a 6-8, 10-minute game guy at a high major program. They dropped down to the mid-major level. They get to where they could start. So the portal, I mean, if you're expecting big-time impact, I think you're asking a lot. I don't think there's a ton of those guys out there in college basketball.
So Jeff Rabjohns of Pigs.com, I can't wait to see you up here next week. Hopefully for you, the team you cover, it's for an extended period of time. And if I'm out and about, you got to slide by and have some drinks with me. You know that.
Absolutely. Are you buying?
Well, I may call Brian Evans and bring him down and let Evans buy. That's what I'm thinking.
Now, that's the plan. I like that. I mean, he's got plenty of money. We can make him spend his quarters.
Make us sleep a hell of a lot better, too. So that's all good as well. All right, brother. I appreciate you.
Always, man. Take care.
Jeff Rabjohns of Pigs.com on the Andy Moore Automotive Group hotline in Madison, Wisconsin, where he is staked out and presumably off the plane and finally got home from Minneapolis not too long ago. He's the voice of the Boilermakers, Rob Blackman. that was like a Planes, Trains, and Automobiles type of saga for you, was it not?
It was, and it came at a bad time for Purdue because they are already in a travel-heavy portion of the schedule, so that added a couple more days to it. But, those are the things you have to work through during a college basketball season. It's interesting here, John, in Madison, sunshine in like mid-40s today, very little snow on the ground.
Man.
It actually feels like springtime and up here in Madison. I can't remember the last time we played up here in basketball and there wasn't, you know, 18 feet of snow on the ground. So it is actually a really nice day up here.
Yeah, that's like tropical up there. It's 60s down here today, too. You get that feel. I mean, even with the women's tournament is underway and you get the men coming up next week and the combine is here. Normally when the combine's here, it's cold, but it is an extremely nice day and it's getting you ready, obviously, for the month of March right here. And, the change of the weather and great basketball, very excited.
I've always said, to me, the best day in Indianapolis, this is just my personal opinion, is if you can get a nice, sunny, warm day on that Thursday of the men's basketball tournament when not everyone, but basically everyone is still in town, right? Most of the teams have not been eliminated at that point, and everyone's out and about downtown walking around enjoying the sunshine and enjoying basketball, and you have all the different Big Ten teams represented by all the great fan bases. There's just something about that first Thursday of the Big Ten tournament. Again, if you can get a nice weather day, I think that's the best day in Indianapolis for me.
All right. Well, let's relive what took place in East Lansing on Saturday. There was a lot of what the hell happened at the end of that game. That was an incredibly winnable game. And I know that it leaves a troublesome, a worrisome piece in the mind of a lot of Boilermaker fans as to, well, this happened in East Lansing. Hopefully this doesn't happen in a one-and-done situation. What type of team are you going to see tonight, and have they decided to go ahead and sweep away the memory of that disappointment on Saturday in East Lansing?
Well, I certainly hope so. I mean, you can't turn it over 17 times and shoot 1 of 9 from three and expect to win. Certainly can't expect to win on the road against a team like Michigan State, which I keep hearing people say, well, they weren't a top 25 team. Well, that is correct. They were 26th, actually, if you want to go through the rankings. They would have been number 26. So certainly still a highly capable team. But regardless, if you're in an NCAA tournament situation and you're 17 turnovers, 1 of 9 from 3,
you're probably going to struggle to find a way to win that game, which is a great irony of that game, John, is that Purdue actually still had a chance to win.
Yeah.
Even as poorly as they played offensively, at least from the three-point shooting. Now, you know, Purdue was getting whatever they wanted inside. I mean, Zach Edey had 25 points. I think Purdue's overall field goal percentage was like 51%. I mean, so you throw the three-point shooting out, Purdue was actually shooting the ball very well inside of the arc. But that advantage in the low post is obviously negated if you're going to turn it over 17 times, right? That's 17 less times you have to throw it in there to Zach Edey and let him do what he needs to do. So I can see why a Purdue fan would be leery of that, because, yes, you are correct. In a one-and-done scenario, 17 turnovers, 1-for-9 from three, you may be going home early in the NCAA tournament. So I certainly get the frustration there. I can tell you I was feeling it myself.
I heard Matt say after the game that I think 7 turnovers at the half, and he had talked to his guys about, hey, let's see if we can keep this thing at a 10 turnover minimum for the game. And by the first media timeout in the second half, they'd already surpassed that. Why so loose with the handles in particular in that second half, Rob?
Yeah, good question. I don't have that answer, but you're correct. The first 5 possessions of the second half, Purdue had the ball to start the second half. First possession, they throw it inside to Zach Edey. He gets a layup. Next 4 possessions were all turnovers, 4 straight turnovers, after you'd just thrown the ball inside and gotten an easy bucket. I mean, Michigan State was playing, 6'8" guys in the low post for most of that game. They played small most of that game. So, again, Zach Edey was just having his way. But, I mean, yeah, you're right. That's exactly what Coach Painter told him. Hey, let's keep the turnovers, at a minimum in the second half. Well, sure enough, you have 4 straight turnovers in the first 5 possessions. So, not good. Why was Purdue so loose with the ball? I don't know. I can tell you this, against Wisconsin, if you're going to be that loose with the ball, you are not going to win this game tonight. I mean, Wisconsin is number 1 in the country in least amount of turnovers per game. They turn it over about 8 times a game, which is the best in the nation. So you know that they are not going to turn it over. So you're not going to get any extra possessions there in the turnover game. And if you give them an extra 9 possessions in turnovers because you're going to turn it over 17 times, I mean, forget about it. Purdue's going to have a long night ahead of them if that's what they do tonight.
Johnny Davis, how do you deal with that defensively? Because, honestly, defense has not been a strong point. And I will say this, Rob. That, to me, is disappointing. Because Matt obviously has preached that. These guys, obviously, to a guy, have a skill set to do it. So, and I mentioned, why so loose with the handle? Why so inaccurate defensively oftentimes? Why is that a subject that continues to haunt them?
Yeah. And you think about this, Coach Painter has always been a defensive first coach, right? I mean, he comes from the Coach Katie cloth, where it's defense first. There's the sign in Mackey Arena that says defense lives here. Well, it really hasn't lived here very much this season. I will say this, Purdue has gotten better. Not great, and I don't think Purdue's going to be a great defensive team. It's too late into the season now to become a good defensive team. It's just too late. You are who you are, right, at this point. But like the last 4 games, I was looking this up earlier today, John, last 4 games, Purdue's allowing 66 points a game. They're turning the other team over a lot, like 45, 46 turnovers in the last 4 games they forced.
Yep.
So they have gotten better defensively. I think they've climbed into the top 100 in defensive efficiency, which I know it's not, that's not great. You're like, wow, the top 100, wow, way to go. But it's a hell of a lot better than they were about, 4 weeks ago.
They were 105 and D and number 1 in offense, right? Nationwide?
In offense, yes. And Purdue still remains number 1 in offensive efficiency in the country, even after that awful shooting performance from 3 against Michigan State. So that shows you how good Purdue is offensively. But yes, defense is a concern. The beauty of the game of basketball is as long as you can score it, then you don't have to be great on defense, right? You're just going to outscore people. But, boy, Purdue's going to have to find a way to score it today because Wisconsin's really good on defense. And, again, offensively, they don't turn it over. They give you very few possessions because they play at an okay pace, not a fast pace, certainly, not a slow pace, but they don't give you a lot of possessions. So in those limited possessions you're going to get, if you're going to turn it over a bunch, you're going to be in a world of hurt tonight.
It's Rob Blackman of the Boilermaker Radio Network, the voice of the Boilers on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Man, I want you to have some fun. I'd like to see this team balance out, get with it, and take off. And honestly, you go back to that Illinois game, and you thought that they were kind of doing that, you know? And, you know, I think you mentioned that a little bit earlier, too. You'd love to see them catch a little bit of fire. And I will say this. This is the type of environment. And, you know, you mentioned, you know, in the past as well, they've had success in Madison. This is the type of game where if you are it, you are that legit, that you could catch a little bit of fire and then kind of run with it. That's maybe what I'm looking for in broader terms from this team a little after 9 o'clock tonight.
Yeah, and you know, it's funny, John, you think about this, and I was actually kind of contemplating this earlier today. Purdue is 24-5. Three of the five losses have essentially come on buzzer beaters, right? So
just say
two of those three don't go in. You know, I mean, now all of a sudden you're probably the number one team in the country. But you're 24-5, you're ranked eighth in the country, and yet you can still find so many flaws with this team. So it's kind of this bittersweet feeling as a fan, right? You're like, oh, my goodness, look how good this team is. They've been ranked in the top 10 the entire season. They only have five losses. Three of them have come on buzzer-beating shots. And yet you feel like this team has so much more left in it. So if indeed that is the case, if indeed Purdue's going to, you know, find that extra gear and put it into take it to another level, I should say, this would be the month to do it. And yes, you are correct. I would like to have a lot of fun myself over the next 4 weeks or so. So that would be just fine with me.
You know, it's funny about it, too. I mean, each of these teams, I mean, you can go, you know, eight or nine certainly deep as far as the top in the nation right now, rankings-wise. And you can pick out some major flaws. We have seen more than a couple of moments this season. But what I'd like to see is a defining player step up. And for this Wisconsin team, Johnny Davis has been there in those moments for them. That's the reason why they find themselves at 23-5 and where they are right now in the Big Ten, because of him. I want to see more in that capacity from Jaden Ivey. Is he capable of carrying this team? I know that they may not need to because of the depth, but I'd like to see him still step up in that capacity. Is he capable of that?
I think he's capable, John, and I would echo your opinion that if he could take it to that Johnny Davis level of just being an absolute a game finisher, if you will, right? I mean, you look right at Wisconsin. They had an interesting nugget in their game notes. They're 14-1 this year in games that have been decided by 6 points or less. I mean, that's an incredible record. So basically, every close game they have been in, they have won, except for one of them. That's it. Which tells me you have a guy like a Johnny Davis on your roster that absolutely has that killer instinct that at the end of the game, you're going to give him the ball and he is going to make a play that allows your team to win a close game down the stretch. And I love Johnny Davis. I mean, when I vote, you know, this weekend for all Big Ten, he's easily first team all Big Ten, probably going to be my Big Ten player of the year.
Yeah, he might be the national player of the year, to be honest with you. Man, I mean, you can make that argument if you wanted to.
So good, without question. Does Jaden Ivey have that killer instinct in him? Yes, I think he does. We've seen it at times this year. Now, for him, it came earlier in the year. You know, that game he had against North Carolina out in Connecticut, where he went for, I don't know, 22 points and whatever it was, 10 rebounds or something like that, 6 assists, I think it was. You know, he's had games like that, but most of his came early in the year, and he's been laboring a little bit here the last couple games. So, which is maybe isn't all bad, because I think about when Purdue went to the Elite Eight and Carson Edwards was really struggling late in the season, and everyone was telling him how terrible he was, and I can't believe Matt Painter keeps playing Carson Edwards all these minutes. Well, we saw what happened in the NCAA tournament. You quickly figured out why Coach Painter was playing Carson Edwards all those minutes. So maybe, who knows, maybe as a Purdue fan, cross your fingers that Jaden Ivey has one of those runs left in him like Carson had in the month of March.
All right. Well, go get yourself a little bit of sun in Wisconsin, where it's a balmy 45, which is balmy, by the way, for the 1st of March in Madison. So, hey, what is before I let you go, what are Matt Painter's numbers in Madison over his career at Purdue? Do you know?
You know, yes, actually, probably as good as anyone in the Big Ten. I'm almost certain they are 5-7 all-time at the Kohl Center. And you think about this, Gene Katie, for all of his success, and to be fair to Coach Katie, the Kohl Center came in very late in his career, so he didn't have a lot of opportunities. But Coach Katie never won a single game at the Kohl Center. And Coach Painter's gone 5-7 in this building. So that's, and there aren't a whole lot of people that win here at the Kohl Center. So Coach Painter does have a track record of having some success against these guys up here.
It's Rob Blackman of the Boilermaker Radio Network's got your call coming up later on tonight. I'm assuming that is an 8 p.m. pregame show. That's a 9 p.m. tip or thereabouts from the Kohl Center in Madison in what is a huge game, not just in the Big Ten landscape, but the college basketball landscape coming up later on tonight. My man, I appreciate you more than you know. And, yeah, I mentioned this to Rab Johns in closing with him, too. You're the same. I mean, I'm going to be downtown a couple of different times. So when you find out your schedule here at the Big Ten tournament, but you got to slide by and have some drinks with me. I'll buy. I wouldn't even like bring Brian Evans to buy those. I'll buy those.
I have never said no to a free beer. So yes. I'll look forward to seeing you next week.
We're taking shots, brother. You got to have shots. Ooh. You got to have shots before you do a game. You got to get good and loose.
Oh, you think I'm Harry Carey here?
we got to get you loose before a game. Anyway, I'll let you know and have a great broadcast tonight, buddy.
Okay, John. Thanks, buddy.
It's Rob Blackman of the Boilermaker Radio Network on the Andy Moore Automotive Group Hotline. Big one in Madison tonight. MLB players reject best final offer from the owners if owners and Commissioner Rob Manfred now follow through on their stated threat. Opening day 2022 will be delayed. Is this like a two-hour delay in schools? It will be delayed, and some number of games in the regular season canceled. Players contingent leaving Florida right now. Ken Rosenthal hit this up. One player leader called the league's proposal, quote, a slap in the face, saying owners want players to lose pay. So there is a great deal of jackassery going on. There you go. So MLB, as it stands right now, does not look like it is going to get started on time. Yeah, I've got what Frank Reich had to say, some quotes. We will sift through that as he met with the media about 30 minutes ago down at the NFL Combine at the Convention Center. Chris Ballard with the media a little bit earlier. We'll go through that. And now I got time for you, 239-1070. Time for you until the top of the hour. So if you want to be on here talking about the Colts and what Ballard had to say, what Reich had to say, we'll do that on the other side. If you want to dive in on the college basketball, the night, as I mentioned, Boilermakers in Wisconsin. You got IU and Rutgers tomorrow night. And you got the Pacers, a loser on the road in Orlando last night. Any of which, that is very reasonable takes and issues that you want to talk about coming up on the other side. We can certainly do that. Let me find the quote that was right here. Is this a real quote? If I'm not going to be able to find it, that's going to drive me insane. Oh, yeah, here it is. I want to give credit where credit is due here. George Brimmer had tweeted this. Reich on Wentz. Are you ready? Quote, I believe he's going to continue to have a lot of success at quarterback. That might be here. That might not be here. I'm sorry. That makes me laugh. He's going to have a lot of success. It may be here and it may not be here. So we really do believe in the quarterback. That means we may not want to quarterback this team next year. Right? We really do believe in the guy that we may not want. Let's go through that. Kyle, that's awesome.
Doesn't that sound a lot like we think Jacoby Brissett is a top 20 QB in the NFL?
Oh my God, that's beautiful. That is beautiful. Yeah, you like MLB? MLB with the school equivalent of the two-hour delay. And much like the two-hour delay does to the parents out there, it screws up your entire day. I'm going to tell you what, MLB, they're going to piss around, and they're going to just push back at all their fans. I mean, constant jackassery. The two-hour delay. I'm sorry. There is nothing more Frank Reich than that Frank Reich quote right there. Seriously, there's nothing more. That's perfect. That is perfect. Quick break. Let's get back to your calls at 239-1070 next.
Big O Tires is locally owned and operated with the lowest price on every tire every day, plus online appointment scheduling and financing made easy. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Jewelry is the greatest gift for the moments you're celebrating. With the largest selection in town, at Shane Company you'll always find meaningful and high-quality gifts in every price range. For a wedding anniversary, I recommend an amazing diamond pendant or an elegant sapphire ring for her right hand. All of our diamonds and sapphires are natural and cut to maximize their beauty. Is there a new baby in the family? Treat mom to a necklace made with 14-karat Italian gold and engraved with the baby's initials. For an upcoming birthday, or if you just want to make someone's day, consider something colorful. We have pendants, earrings, bracelets, and rings made with vibrant sapphires and popular gemstones like Morganite and London Blue Topaz. A gift of fine jewelry from Shane Company will be treasured for a lifetime. Now you have a friend in the jewelry business, Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
When it comes to working at Geico, our best advocates are our employees, like Janet. But since she is so focused on growing her career, we hired an actor to read her story.
At Geico, we really help each other. If anything comes up, we work through it as a group, so we all learn.
As a full-time employee, she can also get paid benefits like medical, dental, vision, and parental leave. She even got a plaque for her desk that says, "I'm kind of a big deal." Yeah, you are, Janet.
Ready to start your career, Indy? We're hiring claim sales and service agents. Apply online today at geico.job/indy.
My crusade for the perfect pizza crust has led me here, pining over a backyard wood-fired oven. But how do I bake this build into my budget? Where can I get some solid guidance on my finances? Who can help me understand if I have the dough for this?
A little financial advice. At Regions, we know that's important because your Life Green checking account comes with Green Print, financial planning with a banker who will help you create a personal budget and live in the moment. Make your appointment at regions.com/greenprint. Regions Bank, member FDIC.
John for Andy Moore, Buick GMC, 131st. It is State Road 37. It is in Fishers. His name is Eric Wilson, and I want to make sure that you talk to him, because if you're looking for a new set of wheels, we're going now into the third month of the new year, 2022. Let's say you've been thinking about it, but you've been hesitant. Why? Because of all these rumors you hear about the lack of inventory. They have the inventory. We can make this one-stop shopping for you. You know you're going to get the best price available from Eric Wilson and the best customer service ever. One-stop shopping, hassle-free. The inventory, the price tag, the customer service you've always been looking for in one place. Ask for my friend Eric Wilson at Andy Moore Buick GMC. That's 131st and State Road 37 in Fishers.
Are you an HVAC technician, plumber, or sewer and drain specialist? Has your company been swallowed up by a national company? Concerned about becoming a small cog in a large wheel? Searching for a place where you can make a difference and feel appreciated? Then call Vasey Commercial Facility Solutions. They're hiring experienced industrial commercial technicians. Get full benefits and true work-life balance. Call Vasey now at 317-873-2512. 317-873-2512. Or go to Vasey.com to learn more.
All right, I'm not currently putting my house in the market, but I can tell you, if I were at this point in time, I would have a little freak out in me. I would, because I just don't know. And oftentimes what you don't know either concerns you or maybe can even scare you. So if you're thinking about doing this, you will be neither. You want to know why? Because you're going to be dealing with the absolute best in realty. That's Mark Dietl, 317-755-4232. MarkDietl.com, Mark DIETEL.com. That's why you go with the best. That's why you go with the trusted best. I've known him for a while. He is the best at what he does. And I mention all the time, too, not knowing things. Well, that's okay if you have somebody that will detail what is going on and will get the job done right for you. In fact, the only agent who guarantees multiple offers in 3 days for full market value, or he's going to list it for free. Go with the best. Go with Mark Dietl. 317-755-4232. That's 317-755-4232. Online, markdietl.com. That's Mark DIETEL.com today.
Message to Amy Spin Class. Happy third 29th birthday, Amy! Exclamation point. Ha ha. Balloon emoji. Balloon emoji. balloon emoji.
You're good at voice to text.
Pizza emoji.
We're good at your insurance. Find an Indiana Farm Bureau insurance agent online, over the phone, or in person. And stop knocking on wood.
Ball got poked free, back out to Langford, and stolen by Finnessy. Finnessy right to the glass in transition, and he finishes with a right hand. Baseball pass up ahead, Romeo Langford right to the glass, and his floater is good. Langford with 16, and that lead is 4 again for New Albany.
There you go, 2016 4A state title game, New Albany 62-59 over McCutcheon. That's Matt Taylor, by the way, voice of the Colts on the call right there. Romeo Langford, New Albany, Robert Finnessy, McCutcheon, the major players in that contest. Langford, of course, was a sophomore at 28 for the Bulldogs. Finnessy, 13 for the Mavericks in that loss. Hey, we start later on tonight around the state. It is round number one of the high school boys basketball tournament, and we have got some fantastic matchups already. This is going to be really fun. Get yourself out to a game. You get a lot for not a lot to get in and to be entertained. For game schedules and locations, that's IHSAA.org today.
The Ride with JMV.
And you can tell Rolling Stone magazine that my last words were, I'm on drugs.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
All right, Jeff Rabjohns, Rob Blackman, Greg Rakestraw, podcast 107.5thefan.com. I will preface everything that I go into by, I completely understand, what else are you going to say? What else are you going to say? But it doesn't make it any less funny. It just doesn't. But understand, I do get, what else are you going to say? This also from George Bremer, who was at both the Ballard and the Wright pressers earlier today down at the Combine. And we knew this from Chris Ballard. Ballard actually met with Wentz for an hour in his office today. Meeting was good. Adds, it will be interesting to see how he grows from this criticism. I think he will. I think that was actually from Ballard earlier today. But yeah. I do. I completely understand why you're not saying anything. But this is like right out of the Reich handbook right here. I believe he's going to continue to have a lot of success at quarterback. That might be here. That might not be here. I love it. I mean, what's not to love? I got a text from a friend, and he says, you know what? This whole situation has really put me off about wanting to spend money on this product. And he was talking about owner, the general manager, the coach. Anybody else feel that way? Does anybody else just say, you know, what the hell is going on? Or do you just conveniently blame me? Is it my problem, my fault? Am I the rabble-rouser here that's making it worse? Well, these guys fully in control, yet it's the big, mean media that's trying to take you down the path of destruction with your favorite team? I mean, how do you view this? I mentioned last week, and maybe it was going too far, that it with again, no reasonable solution in sight, this kind of seems like a fiasco. Does it sniff? Does it reek of a fiasco at all? Is it just the media's fault? God, that is such a lazy ass, incredibly easy, let me pass 3 hour type of argument right there. You know how lazy you have to be to go that way? I mean, listen, give me credit where credit is due. If I'm wrong with an opinion, at least I developed an opinion. At least I did the work to develop opinion, and I didn't sit here and blame it on the media like a lazy ass. Yeah, I developed an opinion. It was wrong. So what? Okay. Call me out. I was wrong about the opinion. At least I developed one. At least I came up with it. At least I worked at it a little bit. Right? So is that what it is? It's our fault for what we're saying about this, and you know, the team, the general manager, Oh, look, you guys see this right now on Facebook Live and YouTube Live. I've got some motions. I mean, they're driving this thing, and they know exactly what's going to go down. It's just all of us that are screwed up. Do I got a you falter here? Oh, I love it. Justin, is this my fault? Justin, hello. Is this my fault?
No, I don't think it's personally your fault. But the one thing I have noticed coming out of 1070 The Fan, which let me preface this, I love you guys. I listen to all three shows. It does seem to be a bit of a smear campaign against Carson. You know, that team fell apart as a team-wise. I mean, that Jaguars game, Kenny Moore got lit up. Darius Leonard was two steps away from making a couple great plays. And, I mean, the whole thing just fell apart. And it seems like Carson is taking the brunt of it. And I think a lot of it's got to do with the fact that, A, he's a ginger. B, he was unvaccinated. And C, that he wears his Christianity on his sleeve like a badge of honor. And I don't think people like that.
But honestly, and listen, this is not ego at all speaking here, but please don't suggest that you think I give a huge crap about any of that, right? I mean, don't. I mean, do you really think I do? Because I don't care about it. My whole thought is I kind of look organizationally at what looks to be a lack of direction more than anything else right now. I mean, listen, I'm not an endorser, as I've mentioned. I'm not an endorser of Wentz. I don't believe he's going to be able to take them anywhere, but I'm not an endorser of him. But I'm certainly more of an endorser of him right now than I would be of whatever else is out there. And, you know, if there's something better out there, I'd be for it. But that's something you don't see right now. And people suggest, well, you're playing the middle of the road. Hey, listen, because the team's playing the middle of the road. The team is playing in the middle of the road right now because, to me, you – and listen, I know this. I know that at the top they don't want to go with him. But they have presented today that they haven't made a decision yet. And to me, if you don't know today, then you know today. And that doesn't make a great deal of sense. And you know today without a reasonable solution does not sound like this organization is a well-oiled machine right now.
Well, I would agree with you 110% on that. And I think Jim's feelings were hurt at the end of the season. I think he went out to the desert, ate some buttons, and started tweeting in the middle of the night. And as much as he would love to get rid of him, they can't get rid of him. There's just nothing out there. And, you know, that's the cold, hard facts about it.
Yeah. Hey, Justin, thank you for the call. I appreciate that. And they are going to get rid of him. That makes it even colder and harder. Man. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Like, I've been fully vaccinated, but I don't care. Like, I never cared. Like, they wanted me to be here, and for me to go out and do what I do and hang out with you guys, I didn't care about, I mean, really, sticking a needle, who cares? Never cared about that. You know how much worse crap I put in this body? I mean, I know right now you're looking at it on YouTube Live or Facebook Live, and I know this is a chiseled piece of granite. You know how much crap I didn't care about that. I love me some Hagen. My man's got nothing but red. And I never really bought into that. I'd rather be dead than red on the head like a bark at a log. Like, you ever heard of that? I can't say the rest of it. The bark on the log and on a dog. But no, seriously. None of that matters. None of that matters. And here's part of it. Part of it is maybe they are. Maybe they are thinking about what's out there and what they can't risk right now. I just don't think that to be the case. I think the decision's been made. I mean, it doesn't even look to me like it's not even a Wentz thing as it is. It's an organization thing that looks like I don't know about the path right now. It makes you question it. Because in year 5 going into year 6 for both coach and general manager, there should be a much clearer path at this point. Man, Hagen's going, what? That's pretty classic right there. Hey, JMV, do you think the Colts are moving to an already established quarterback in the league, or do they think that they're looking to draft somebody somehow and start fresh? I doubt Ellinger is the answer either. Man, I wish, Brett, I had an answer for you, but I don't. And, man, that's all I do is look at this crap. And no matter what I say, I either come off as a guy that believes in Wentz, even though he's not the guy to get them to where they want to go, or a guy on a smear campaign for Wentz. I mean, I know that he's not going to get them to where they want to go. I'm just looking at the options of next year. And listen, whatever, I mean, that is water under the bridge with that 1-3 is gone. I mean, the stain of that trade, no matter how this thing ends up going, if he's not the quarterback for the second year, I mean, that is going to stick with this team for a while. Frank did say a little bit earlier that he stuck his neck out, and he did stick his neck out. I mean, he's the one that sold Jim Irsay on it. And Chris Ballard was in on that too. And, you know, Jim Irsay told us last spring that he had to be sold on this. So, yeah, there is no doubt that he is incredibly pissed to a point of no return. All right, quick break and we'll come back with you. We got full phones and I'll deal with that. We got anybody here at the 5 o'clock hour? We all free. All right, we got you coming up at the 5 o'clock hour. I got tickets for you. I'll recalibrate, get back with you on the other side next.
If you love listening to our shows, then you've got to follow us on our social media. You can find us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. Search 107.5 The Fan and share your opinions with us on our posts.
Hey guys, looking for a reason to spend 3 days on the couch watching basketball? Schedule your vasectomy at Urology of Indiana for a Thursday or Friday, then sit back, relax, and catch some games over the weekend while you recover. It may be the only time your wife approves of hoarding the couch and the remote control. Vasectomies at Urology of Indiana are simple and typically take only about 15 minutes. Soon after, you'll be out the door and on your way home. During your recovery, you'll take ibuprofen and be back to your normal activities in 3 days. The docs at Urology of Indiana are board certified and perform vasectomies every day of the week, all year long. They're pros at what they do, and they have multiple vasectomy clinics, so chances are good there's one close to you. If you've been putting off your vasectomy, now is the time. You'll never have a better excuse to watch basketball. Call Urology of Indiana or visit vasectomyindy.com for information and to schedule an appointment. That's vasectomyindy.com.
Are you feeling the pinch of higher prices?
Costs may be rising, but with Golden Oak Lending's 2.25% fixed rate, you can lower your mortgage payments.
James Hawkins here, president of Golden Oak. You can offset today's high prices by using the low interest equity in your home to pay off credit cards, make home improvements, or simply put cold hard cash back in your pocket.
It only takes a few minutes to see if you can save hundreds with this low 2.25% rate.
So what are you waiting for? Lock in our low rate while you still can. Start saving money and skip your first two mortgage payments.
Call your local loan officers at 317-706-GOLD today and pay nothing out of pocket.
That's right. If we can't close your loan, the appraisal is no charge.
Golden Oak Lending cured my blues.
NMLS 114937. 2.25% fixed, 3.336% APR, FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Daughtry. Heavy in the crowd. The Dearly Beloved Tour. The multi-platinum, multi-award winner returns. This Saturday night at 7, Marat Theater at Old National Center. Special guests, Tremonti and Lyle. Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com or OldNationalCenter.com. The Dearly Beloved Tour.
Sound of the world on fire.
Hey, John here for the absolute best in plumbing. I love Lance and his local team at LD Smith Plumbing. And you know what? You will, too. The best in central Indiana to get the job done right for you. Hey, let's all check out our house main drain. They have something that they're going to offer up called 83 or free. To clear that main drain, this is a great offer. And I want you to take advantage of it. 317-284-9526. That's Lance and his local team at LD Smith Plumbing. Just ask for the 83 or free for your main drain clearing with our friends, the best in plumbing at LD Smith Plumbing. 317-284-9526 online. That's ldsmithplumbing.com today.
It's Super Cash time at Old Navy. Right now, redeem your $10 in Super Cash and save $10 on every $25 purchase. Use it on everything. Run to Old Navy or OldNavy.com today. Valid 226 to 36. Excludes gift cards and clearance. See OldNavy.com/SuperCash for more details.
At HeroLoan.com, we always keep it 100. Get the loan that you've earned and keep it 100 at HeroLoan.com. The only way to VA.
NMLS number 1326-241.
Wednesday on Kevin Aquari, we're live at the NFL Combine, recapping what Chris Ballard and Frank Reich had to say, and obviously touching on Purdue and Wisconsin as well. Join us at 7 a.m.
The Ride with JMV.
Hey, you going to stare all day or are you going to buy something?
I'm going to stare all day.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
I got a 5 o'clock hour that's wide-ass open for today. That's a busy 4 o'clocker right there. A little Boilermaker Wisconsin conversation. Rob Blackman, voice of the Boilermakers. IU Rutgers tomorrow night in Bloomington. Jeff Rabjohns of Pigs.com. Greg Rakestraw all over the map a little bit earlier. From the Colts to college basketball. High school-wise underway with sectional play. First round action. Good luck to everybody as they embark. Man, sectional time of year is spectacular. Take advantage of it and get out to a game. JMV, I blame you for everything. When I forget things, when I'm wrong, I get myself in big trouble, I blame you specifically. Not the media, just you. Thank you, Jim. Yeah, it's all me. It is. I'm telling you, that is one of the late... Listen, when somebody does that, just know that it's lazy. It's lazy and it's easy. Nothing goes into that. It's like back in the day. It's like, I'll be honest with you. For the past month and a half, everybody says this. Why do you continue to go with the Carson Wentz? It's tired. You're just being lazy. You know, I don't think I'm being lazy, but it does wear me out. Here's the problem that I have. That it is a supply and demand issue. You demand it. I mean, if you didn't want to hit it, you didn't want me to talk about it, I wouldn't supply it. I'd supply something else, but it is supply and demand. But it doesn't mean it doesn't wear me out. To try to continue to come up with a different angle on this, to continue to go back with, well, this is what I've heard and this is what's going to happen. I mean, at least we got a little freshness today. I guess if you want to call it that, it just, and again, I know that they have to say that, but it doesn't sound any less ridiculous. It just doesn't. March 1, and you don't know. 1 year in, a 1 and a 3, poof, gone. You know, on the hook for 15 mil if you cut. You know, having to live with it for another year if you don't. And as of right now, you don't know. I mean, what is going to be the determining factor? Like Golden Retriever Mom or whatever said earlier today, well, they're just trying to gauge what his answers are. We? I mean, I don't know about that. I don't know about that at all. It sounds kind of messed up. All right, quick break, and we'll come back with a lot of this messed up dialogue coming up next. If you guys want to jump in, you certainly can. YouTube Live, you can find us on Facebook Live as well. Rakestraw, Rabjohns, Blackman Podcast, 107.5thefan.com. Wide open, 5 o'clock hour with you next.
Hey, guys, it's the new year. Are you still struggling with erectile dysfunction? I've yet to meet anyone that enjoys timing those intimate moments around a pill. Well, Now you don't have to. The advanced wave technology at Pine Grove Medical Clinic has been shown by Cambridge University and the Cleveland Clinic to restore and even regrow blood vessels. It can improve circulation and eliminate erectile dysfunction. No pills and no side effects. If you're ready to put a stop to your ED, call us in the next 2 minutes and you'll receive a consultation, assessment, and blood flow ultrasound free. Plus, a special gift that produces immediate results in the bedroom. You're going to love that. Trust me. This is a $600 value, free to callers now. 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, get rid of your ED and get that spark back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. 317-552-1111.
Hey, Johnny for Race Trash Service. Hey, new gig. You're looking for a new career? Do you have a commercial driver's license? You want great pay, incredible benefits for a company that's been locally operated, family operated since the 1960s? How about Race Trash Service, especially if you're thinking about being a driver? You got that commercial driver's license. Log on, apply today, racetrash.com. Now, if you're not a driver, if you'd like to do something else, you can do that as well. They have non-driving opportunities for you at Ray's Trash. Apply today at raystrash.com.
Bet on more than the final score with One Game Parlay at BetMGM. One Game Parlay is designed to help you make selections within a single game from over 400 bet types, including team and player props. Log into your BetMGM account and create your best parlay before the game starts. New to BetMGM? Well, sign up today and make your first bet risk-free up to $1,000 with the bonus code THEFAN. That's all one word, capital T, capital F. Plus, you'll earn BetMGM rewards points that can be redeemed for online bonuses or converted into comps for rooms, restaurants, and more at over 20 MGM resorts nationwide. Try One Game Parlay today. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. Must be 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana only, new customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credit. Free bets expire 7 days from issuance. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Wow, I've got a whole 5 minutes before my next call. What should I do? Grab a snack? Nah. Text with mom? That's more than a five-minute proposition. I have been looking at getting a new bank account. Is that even possible?
Can't believe you have extra time? You won't believe what you can do with it. Open a Regions checking account online in as little as 5 minutes. Then enjoy award-winning service and banking tools and tech that help you live in the moment. Learn more at regions.com/live-in-the-moment. Regions Bank, member FDIC.
Hey, Johnny for LD Smith Plumbing. That is the best in plumbing. Anywhere in central Indiana, if you have any issues, especially those emergency issues, that number's 317-284-9526. Always count on the best, and especially in an emergency with Lance and his local team at LD Smith Plumbing. Also, if you're thinking about getting that main drain in your home cleared, 83 or free is the offer right now. I want you to take full advantage of that. Always giving you the best service and incredible deals. 83 or free on clearing your main drain in your home. Going on right now with LD Smith Plumbing. Call and ask about it today. 317-284-9526. Or to find out more online, that's ldsmithplumbing.com today.
Switch to Spectrum Mobile and get unlimited data for only $29.99 per month each when you get two or more lines. You could save hundreds on your mobile bill. Plus, there are no added taxes, hidden fees, and no contracts. Try the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator today, and in three easy steps, you'll see how much you could save. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Offer valid for new customers on two or more unlimited lines. Spectrum Internet required. Restrictions apply. Visit SpectrumMobile.com for details.
This is Claudia's O'Reilly Auto Parts story.
I had just moved to a new city and barely even knew where the grocery store was yet. When my car wouldn't start one morning, I didn't know who to ask about local shops. But I remembered a name from back home, O'Reilly Auto Parts. I called and they pointed me to a great mechanic just down the street. Now I feel a little more at home.
O'Reilly Auto Parts.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB, WIBC HD3 W228CX, Indianapolis.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan. The Ride with JMV.
Let me have a Diablo sandwich of Dr. Pepper. Make it fast. I'm in a damn hurry.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
So I'm watching Jeff Passan on ESPN. And let me first tell you that that's exactly the background that I would have. Or like it, right? It wouldn't be exactly like it. Because I would have the Atari 2600 instead of a Nintendo. He's got Pink Floyd, Dark Side of the Moon, I think, on the back wall. I think Rage Against the Machine on the back wall. Let me see what else he has back there. He's got an old box of unopened Topps baseball cards. I mean, I'd have different stuff up there, right? I'd probably have a lunchbox or two back there. Maybe Gomer Pyle, USMC. Have a Warriors poster, movie poster, something like that. But Passan's background looks a lot like the 40-year-old virgin's apartment. You notice that? Remember Steve Carell's apartment and the 40-year-old virgin? I thought it was great. But then you had Rogan... Seth, not Joe. He had Rogan and Rudd and that other guy come in and Cheney had to get rid of all his vintage toys and his Asia poster. Passan's not 40, is he? You think he's like the 40-year-old virgin? Is he 40? He's no way he's 40. He kind of reminds me of the movie Big. When the kid returned to normalcy after he was Tom Hanks, the adult for a while, and he still had on Tom Hanks' suit, and it was way too big for him. That's what that reminds me of.
He's 41.
41? I would not have known. So he is not the 40-year-old virgin.
You would think.
Does he look? He kind of looks like that. Remember him Big at the end when he went back to being a kid from Tom Hanks, but he was still wearing the clothes, the suit, and walking in the shoes. That's what that reminds me of. But I would have a background very similar to that. Not exactly like that, but very similar to it. So I guess you could reference me and my metal lunchbox collection as the 40-year-old virgin. This is something from Kevin Bowen, who was at that Frank Reich presser back in the 4 o'clock hour, regarding Reggie Wayne. I've been talking to Reggie about getting on the staff for 4 years. Reggie is a guy who I have the utmost respect for. I'm a big believer in him as a person, as a competitor, as a winner. If we can get that all locked up, I think it will be a big deal. It hurts losing Coach Groh. That's Mike Groh, who went to the Giants. We allowed him to make that move for some personal reasons that were good for his family. But I'm excited about the prospect of taking that final step with someone like Reggie. That's regarding Reggie Wayne. Frank Reich with the media a little bit earlier. We've been talking about that, too. At JMV, Carson Wentz had 27 TDs and only 7 interceptions, and the 15th-ranked quarterback, or I should say QBR, sorry, all with a crap pass protection, no over-the-top receiver, no tight end. Stands to reason if they plug those holes, Carson Wentz should improve exponentially. And, Joe, I have said this, and this does not make me a believer in Carson Wentz, but to me, given what you know about this situation, it would be much easier and reasonable to do that than adding a quarterback to the mix here. And by the way, in an off season where there are no quarterbacks of reason in the mix. No, I mean, that makes plenty of sense. Now, again, 27-7, that are his numbers, right? But, I mean, we can look back at games in which certainly his play was costly, to be fair in this. But no, you are right. That's why not a lot of this makes sense. Because you know you got to add, and at least Chris Ballard did go today and say, hey, you know, we got to get better at wide receiver. Well, duh. like 4.5 years later. Thanks for joining the program there, GM. It's been a while. Thanks for joining us. But now, you know, not only do you have to do that, but I'm assuming that they've found their left tackle, and that left tackle is going to continue to be Eric Fisher. But you got a lot of work to do with this team, and if there's nothing out there right now, it just seems like you add a lot more that could make it a lot worse. And again, I'm not a big believer. I've got to see some sort of solution. I guess I'm not somebody that just says, you know what, cut it and see what Ellinger is. I think we know that. I mean, I guess it stands to reason if you believe a guy like Jameis Winston would be better. Or a guy like Mitchell Trubisky would be better. But again, I mean, going this direction in which they're going, it sounds more like Jim is the one that said, hey, you know what? Absolutely not. Kyle and I were talking about this a little bit earlier. It sounds like the owner says, absolutely not. Ballard goes, hey, we can give it another try. And Reich, or Ballard would be cool either way. And then Reich would like to give it another try. And again, the assumption here is I think you know who's going to win that argument. If there is an argument. JMV, if David Bell is still in the second round, you got to get him, right? Any chance he might be? Yeah, I don't know where David Bell is going to go. I would like to get him on the show. Last time we had him on, remember he had phone issues, I think, halfway through it. That's the last time we talked to him. It was just and gone. Yeah, it's funny where they are right now. You know, I mentioned this last week. I'd mentioned this last week that it kind of seems this kind of sniff of kind of a fiasco here. Or is there something, because there's the unknown we don't know. Is that saving you? I will tell you this, and I've said this all along, they are fortunate in this fashion. Here's why. Because there are more people out there that just say, I don't care who it is. It just can't be number two again. I mean, it's not, you know, 95%, for example, of the Colts fan base, but it is more than those that would say, hey, go ahead and give this another try. I mean, it would make more sense if there was something, if there was a target out there that we would understand. And you didn't expect it today. And I told you not to expect it, but there was no clarification whatsoever. There was just saying some stuff to get past the question that was asked about their quarterback. That's what it was. Somebody called me middle of the road yesterday. There was nothing more middle of the road than what you heard today. And I completely understand that they had to. All right, 239-1070 is the number. Me and you for the full hour here if you want to go that direction. Chris, thanks for joining the show. How are you? Hello, Chris. I'm with you.
Hey, good to talk to you. So, a name I've not heard anyone mention. How bad can Gardner Minshew be?
Well, I'm assuming pretty bad. I would guess he can be bad, yeah. Right? I mean, to answer your question,
Might as well give that a go. Can't be any worse than what we got.
Well, it might. It might be. I mean, it may not be, but it might be. I think that's the point. Like, I don't know, and thank you, Chris, for the call. Like, I'm sorry if you're going to have to sell me a little bit more in doing all this and then having to live with that fiasco of a trade and eat 15 mil to unearth on the other side of this starting in 2022 as your quarterback with the Colts, Gardner Minshew. I mean, let's face it. The only thing that you like about that is his name's not Carson Wentz. That's it. That's the only thing you like about it. I mean, it's the only thing. And then keep in mind, too, I mean, Wentz is not... Let's just say Gardner Minshew would not, he'd be playing here. He wouldn't be in Jacksonville playing against the Colts. and the Colts defense. That is the only thing that you like about it. There is no redeeming quality there other than it's a new name and his name is not Wentz. JMV, get Wentz, Robinson, Cooper, and see what he can do. Again, fully understand, I am not a complete backer of Wentz. I mean, when you present something to me, Gardner Minshew or Carson Wentz, I mean, just think what you have to do to get to Gardner Minshew. All that work to get to Gardner Minshew, all that work to get to Mitchell Trubisky, all that work to get to Jameis Winston. Now, all that work to get to Russell Wilson, now you're talking. But then John Clayton would probably F-bomb me if I brought that up again. I mean, you give me a better quarterback, then I would be on board with it. But you got to give me a better quarterback or better alternative, a better option, better anything. Oh, the quotes today were absolutely, you're right, they were absolutely priceless. Passon says MLB has canceled the first two series of the season. Is this officially sticking the fork in baseball here? Is this the first work stoppage since 94? The first cancellation of games for a lockout work stoppage?
If you don't count the COVID thing.
I don't count the COVID.
Yeah, 94.
My, what a level of jackassery. I'm going to tell you what, there is nothing better, right? There is nothing better. It's one thing to lose to your professional competition, like the NFL. One thing to lose to college football competition, late summer or early fall. But, man, it is one thing to just do yourself in. I mean, it is... hard work to do yourself in like this. Incredible. That is an absolute clown show. Hey, JMV, if you had to keep Wentz for another year, would you trade Jonathan Taylor for Davante Adams or Cooper Kupp? Well, there's no way that either one of those guys, Davante Adams is going to get franchise tagged. He's going to be a free agent. Cooper Kupp is not going to go anywhere until he shows signs of, would you call it regression, I guess? Because one of these days he's going to take a lot of hits and he's going to slow down. I mean, it's just a fact of life as you grow in the NFL. And they're not going to trade Jonathan Taylor for anybody. It's just, I mean, you think about this. When somebody tells you, well, there's still a lot of time to win, running backs in the NFL don't have a lot of time. Jonathan Taylor does not have a lot of time. I mean, this offensive line doesn't have a lot of time. I mean, let's face it. This offensive line, which was supposed to be the best in the NFL this past season, was far from it. Listen, I'm not talking about the numbers that were crunched by PFF and the guys that I like a great deal, but we watched it. The thing absolutely wilted in Jacksonville. You guys buy that the Colts don't know right now? I actually asked that question because I had a Twitter follower ask it a little bit. Do you think that today that was Ballard saying that Wentz was going to be their guy? Because I didn't hear that at all. The only thing I heard is if you're non-committal right now as they are, if you're playing both sides, if you're in the middle as they are, then you know. It's not as if you don't know right now. If you're non-committal right now, then you don't know. Or check that, you do know. I mean, if it's March 1, why can't you waltz out there and say, yeah, you know what? Not a lot of options. I think Bruce Arians talked about the lack of options at quarterback that are out there this year. And again, that's the thing. Without my endorsement of Carson Wentz, which you're not going to get, but if you look at all the work you have to go through to get on the other side, to get to some of these names, I don't understand why you're jumping through all these hoops to do that. Aaron's up next at 239-1070. Aaron, welcome to the show. How are you?
Doing well. How are you?
Great. Go ahead.
I just want to make a comment about Carson and the pressure on him. You know, if he, say we do bring him back for another year, we give him a better supporting cast, who's to say the pressure that the city is placing on him to play way better than he did or even just a bit better than he did last year isn't going, you know, can he hold handle that pressure?
I can't tell you that he's going to be any better. I wouldn't sit here and try to tell you he's going to be any better. I think my philosophy right now, Aaron, is that if you're going to go through all this work and knowing what this team needs right now and knowing what you know about the landscape of quarterback, it just seems to me like this going with what you have would make more sense than trying to go with some of these names and then jumping through those hoops, you know, and making it look worse with that trade moving forward. Now, listen, that's what they're going to do. I mean, they're going to move forward and go someplace else. I just, to me, it doesn't make that much sense, knowing that there's no legitimate option out there. So that's what doesn't make sense to me. But I can also be a non-believer in him, and he's not going to win them a Super Bowl anytime soon. I mean, hell, he may not win them an AFC South. And, you know, you may be right. Everybody else out there that wants to get started with anybody else right now may be right. Listen, why would you sit there another year with a guy that you don't believe in? And that ultimately what this thing to me is going to come down to.
Right. And if you give somebody like Mitchell Trubisky another chance, he's going to come in with a chip on his shoulder, whereas Carson's already...
Yeah, and he'll probably suck, too. Yeah. I sound like negative Nelly right now, and I don't want to sound like that. But, yeah, Mitchell Trubisky will suck, and Gardner Minshew will suck, and all these guys will probably suck.
Right. Right. No, I agree.
Amen. Aaron, I appreciate your phone call. Thank you very much. I don't mean to sound negative, but give me a better alternative. I mean, give me a better alternative, a quarterback, and I'll be with you on this. the pressure. Yeah. I still don't know if this pressure that everybody is talking about on Wentz right now and what he's going through, I mean, there's nothing going to compare to Philadelphia. I mean, you can have 5 or 6 little Doyles running around or 5 or 6 me's or anybody else, and it's not going to compare to what he went through at the end of that time in Philadelphia. I mean, am I missing a better option? If I am, tell me. If I am, tell me. Kyle, you got a better option for me? Lay it on me.
If the Packers, make up with Aaron Rodgers and Jordan Love is on the table, would you be interested in Jordan Love?
Well, I will say this. He's interesting to me because then you would also be doing something that a lot of people have been talking about doing for a long time. And if you remember, I brought up Justin Fields. And, you know, had you looked back on that, and if you knew that he was going to fall that far, and if Philip Rivers would have given them another year, this is hypothetical, then maybe you would have tried to draft a young quarterback. And he does give you that young quarterback, and he was also a guy that they liked a great deal, if you remember, in that particular draft. So, listen, I would be willing to listen to that. I would listen to that. And even though I'm not suggesting that he would come in here and going to win you an AFC South, but at least that would feel like you're back on track from being in this quarterback abyss.
You don't know what the Packers would want for him in a trade. You'd have to trade for him. But he is on a rookie deal for a few more years. It's just his one start last year versus Kansas City.
It was a mess.
It was a disaster.
But, I mean, at least that would be You know, that would be essentially like if you thought that Jacob Eason was the guy. And I'm not suggesting they had Jacob Eason on the team, but, you know, if Jacob Eason would have showed any signs whatsoever or had the opportunity to show any signs whatsoever of which we could see, then I think people would be on board with trying to have him with the rest of the team. It's just, if you go back out there and try to find these quick fix Band-Aids and eat $15 million and make this trade for Wentz look worse than it is, I mean, at least you're talking about a young quarterback where you did have belief in him coming out of the draft. What was it, 3 years ago, 2 years ago now?
2 years ago, yeah. But also, I mean, the Packers have had him now for two seasons. And kind of like what the Chiefs did with Mahomes, they saw how special he was going to be. And granted, Rodgers is a lot better than Alex Smith, but they pushed Alex Smith out the door. And obviously the Packers want to keep Rodgers for as long as
I would, I would do that. That would be one reasonable scenario that I would listen to.
I think it's a better option than that Minshew may end up or being Trubisky reasonable. Or Mariota or Winston.
Anybody out there buying the Jordan Love thing? I would listen to that. It's tough for me to sit here and listen to Gardner Minshew and Mitchell Trubisky. But I would listen to that. Did Ballard cross Jordan Love off the big board because of weed? I think Bowen talked about that. I don't know. I would put him on my big board for weed. I mean, I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. I may cross Quentin Nelson off the big board because he can't play left stinking tackle. I mean, maybe, Bobby. I'm not making fun of maybe that is true, but I wouldn't give a fat crap about that. And I guess that also was just me not giving a fat crap about weed in general, right? I mean, look at this quarterback situation. You don't have a lot of options, a lot of reasonable options, and especially one with a considerable ceiling of possible growth. Sparking up someplace would be the last thing I would really care about. And honestly, that's why I don't even care about it right now. Spark up, baby. I'm just joking. Don't do it. Because it's still illegal, and it will be until we're all dead here. Ballard said he's going after wide receiver depth and not playmaker. That's not playmakers. Well, he's got to go after wide receiver depth. BT says, remember Jordan Love fell in the draft. Listen, part of this thing is anywhere you go, there seems to be issues. I'm just telling you with the hypothetical that Kyle brought up, I like the growth of a younger quarterback moving forward than I would going after some of these guys that have been around for a while for a quick fix. I'm not suggesting that's going to happen, but when he presented me that, I would much rather do that than try to bring in Gardner Minshew. I would probably put him back on my big board for weed. I think you automatically get on my big board for weed. Even though it's incredibly illegal and don't do it. Unless you're in Michigan or Colorado or California, then you can do what you want. Hey, JMV, I recognize this will never happen. However, how do you think it would be received if Carson Wentz was to publicly acknowledge his best opportunity is with Coach Reich next year, and he is willing to restructure his agreement to make it incentive-laden rather than upfront payment? Now, I don't know contractually if you can do that. I don't know why he would have to do that right now. And I don't know if that has anything to do with Reich. This is more with the owner. I mean, this really starts with the owner. So I would say no, James, just because I don't think it would be necessary. I mean, you wouldn't have to prove that to Reich, I don't think. And again, I think this is a foregone conclusion anyway. Hey, quick break. We'll come back to your calls. Am I way over here? Actually, I'm not, but we got time for you on the other side. I've got America tickets down in Brown County. That is the Brown County Music Center. That is a great band from the 70s and the 80s. It is a yacht rocker right now. That's in June, and it's going to be a blast. You're going to see me there as well. I got America tickets before we end this here show. Don't leave.
Hi, I'm a jewelry consultant at Shane Company. Visit us and you'll be dazzled by our stylish selection of jewelry you'll enjoy wearing every day. We have lots of styles you can personalize. Just select your favorite gemstone to create a one-of-a-kind necklace or ring. You can choose a radiant ruby or a sapphire. We have over a dozen colors, or a purple amethyst, London blue topaz, or peach morganite. We're known for our vibrant, natural gemstones. Customers love our signature shade of rose gold. It has a soft blush tone. We have all the classics in rose gold, hoop earrings, studs, tennis bracelets, you name it. We also have gorgeous gold chains in a variety of styles, including herringbone chains, paperclip chains, and more. If you want something extraordinary, check out Tom's Finds, our limited edition collections featuring rare gemstones from around the world. Whether you're looking to build your jewelry wardrobe with a classic, or you just want to treat yourself, come in and have some fun.
Now you have a friend in the jewelry business, Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
Hi, I'm Ryan Kelly with TheHomeLoanExpert.com. The real estate market is beyond competitive. Getting your offer accepted is like an Olympic sport. You need a solid team. I'll get you pre-approved within minutes and locked in at a low interest rate. And with my 21-day closing guarantee, you'll be bringing home the gold in your new dream home. Don't let working with the wrong lender ruin your home buying experience. Get pre-approved today for your new home purchase at thehomeloanexpert.com. The Home Loan Expert LLC, NMLS number 1326241.
This isn't just a song. It's an anthem for a community of millions that has turned the melody into its mantra. And this May, it's the tune that's calling us to come back together again, to come back to the spectacle, to come.
Back home again in Indiana.
The Indianapolis 500, Sunday, May 29th. Visit IMS.com for more information.
Hey, John here from Mark Dito Realty. I'm telling you, big monetary situations freak me out. They do. I've got to have some guidance, and I mean big time, especially if I were to put my house, my property on the market. What would I do? Of course, I would call Mark Dietl, 317-755-4232. It's markdietl.com, markdietel.com today. He is incredible at what he does. All 100% trust in what he is going to do for me, what he is going to do for you. And I like somebody that comes with guarantees, especially guarantees like this. Multiple offers in 3 days for full market value, or he's going to list it for free. I'm telling you, if you're going to put your house in the market because you're downsizing, maybe kids are moving out and going to college in the spring, or if you're going the family and you want a little bit more property, go with the best. That's Mark Dietl. 317-755-4232. That's 317-755-4232. MarkDietl.com, MarkDietel.com today.
Ready to save more on your mobile bill? With Spectrum Mobile, get unlimited data and nationwide 5G for just $29.99 per month when you get two or more lines. All with no contracts, added taxes, or hidden fees. And now for a limited time, you can save up to $300 on the new Samsung Galaxy S22 series. This is the epic new smartphone you've been waiting for. Visit SpectrumMobile.com today for details. Offer valid for new customers on two or more unlimited lines. Spectrum internet required. Subject to change. Visit SpectrumMobile.com for offer details.
Are you an HVAC technician, plumber, or sewer and drain specialist? Has your company been swallowed up by a national company? Concerned about becoming a small cog in a large wheel? Searching for a place where you can make a difference and feel appreciated? Then call Vasey Commercial Facility Solutions. They're hiring experienced industrial commercial technicians. Get full benefits and true work-life balance. Call Vasey now at 317-873-2512. 317-873-2512. Or go to Vasey.com to learn more.
Join 93.1 WIBC right down the dial for Indiana University basketball as the Hoosiers take on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights Wednesday night at 6 p.m. for the pregame show.
The Ride with JMV.
If peeing your pants is cool, consider me Miles Davis.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan. Said our husband's work is never through. We making it 'cause we making moves. The only thing we know how to do.
said it's the only thing we know how to do. Work hard, play hard, work hard, play hard. We work hard, play hard, keep partying like it's your job. Work hard.
Hey, welcome back to the show. Rake Straw, Rab Johns, Blackman, podcast 1075thefan.com. A little bit earlier today, got a big one tonight in Madison between the Boilermakers and Wisconsin. See if the Boilermakers can get up off of what took place on Saturday in East Lansing. Jeff Rabjohns, IU Rutgers coming up in Bloomington on senior night tomorrow night, and Greg Raystraw on a variety of things. And we're deep into the Wentz, deep into the Ballard and the Wright conversations earlier today, as I'm sure we will be for a while. Yeah, the weed puts you back on my big board right there. you're dealing with your body. That's pretty funny. It's from Will. Hey, JMV, Winston could take the Colts to the Super Bowl. He can sling it. I've never seen him do a ballerina twirl and throw the ball underhanded in the air for a pick six. Yeah, what was that game against the Colts? He threw for about 500 yards and 27 touchdowns and threw about six picks in that game, too. It was amazing. That was more of a product of the Colts' defense than it was anything. JMV, good show today, covering a lot of ground, though I feel I have more questions now. I miss the days of playing against you in the mornings. That's Brett Wampler right now with my friend Mark Barnheiser at Perry Meridian High School. I love those mornings. I miss those mornings. I miss having to stop and like have a fight and then get back to it. I can't believe it's been over 20 years since then. There were years, when I move up here in 98, I basically played every single morning at Perry Meridian High School with Barnheiser from 98. This is just a Perry Meridian because I did it from 93 until 98 and then moved up here and played from 98 until around 05 every day. Hey, there's a reason why I'm the best 52-year-old shooter around here. There's no doubt about that. Every day. I just can't move. Inside the Lounge via YouTube Live, you guys have been fantastic today. Facebook Live as well. I got America tickets I'll give away before the top of the hour. Daniel's up next at 239-1070. Hello, Daniel. How are you?
Good. How you doing, sir?
I'm great. Go ahead.
Couple things. I don't understand why Braden Smith never gets brought into the left tackle conversation. I mean, I understand that Q is the bell of the ball and he's a Hall of Fame left guard, but why can't Braden Smith play left tackle?
Yeah, I mean, he must be more versatile than Nelson because he moved from playing guard in college to playing right tackle in the NFL, and that's something that your $20.5 million left guard is apparently incapable of doing. But no, it sounded to me like today, and this was not during the press conference. This was kind of off to the side afterwards. It sounded to me like that they were going to try to reboot Eric Fisher at left tackle this year. At least that's the way it sounded to me.
Yeah. Also, I think Carson Wentz needs Rene Russo from Tin Cup because I think he's just got a between the ears problem more than anything else. He got the tools. He just needs a little DBAP situation.
I love Tin Cup. I love that movie. I mean, it's outrageously stupid. You know, it's funny. That came out in, what, 96 or 97? When was Jean Vandeveld at the British Open? Was that in the early 2000s? Because he kind of did himself. Remember when he got his ball in the water in that creek, in that ditch, and he kept trying to hit out of it? It was very Tin Cup-esque. Big Tin Cup fan over there. Have you seen that with Costner and Russo?
I haven't seen it.
Cheech Marin?
That was Don 99, Johnson? Though. 99.
Don Johnson's golf swing. Like, Costner was legit in his golf swing. Don Johnson's golf swing was not. He was much better as Crockett in Miami Vice. And, again, let's note for future reference that Kyle has yet to see Tin Cup. I did like it. Like, it's funny. The Ron Shelton movies built around sports, I liked it. Like, White Men Can't Jump. I can go like, I can go up until Wesley Snipes screws over Woody Harrelson. And then I think it gets really sucky after that. And I don't know why. I don't know why they went with the Jeopardy and Rosie Perez storyline as long as they did. It's like, man, we don't have anything else to put here. Let's do that. Shout out to Ron Shelton movies. JMV, I think Wentz returns and they roll with it. Inflation on classic rock guitars will make Ursay want to save $15 million. I think he's worried about that. Actually, he's not worried about that at all. Full disclosure. Can you find that cut from Reich where he talked about, I think he's going to be good if he's here or if he's not here? See if you can find that. I love that. Listen, I know that's what you have to say, and I know they weren't going to say anything more than that, but both Ballard and Reich were classic Ballard and Reich today. It was classic. Let's see how long we can talk without saying anything to answer your question. It was beautiful. And really, that's a learned skill. Does not make it any less beautiful, however. Hey, JMV, 27 and 7 are good skill numbers. One skill to bring to a quarterback that does not get measured is the skill of leadership. I just don't see Wentz as a leader. I'll be honest with you. I haven't talked about that. I haven't talked about the negativity that many have brought up as far as his locker room presence because I have not been told that. And that is not something that I know. I guess it would stand to reason, would we have seen any of that type of stuff in Hard Knocks? I mean, any type, if there was a hint of him being a bad locker room guy, would we have seen any of that reflective in Hard Knocks?
We never saw anything bad, but we never saw him being that great, you know, rah-rah, let's go.
I mean, he walked, yeah, guy. I mean. I think the only thing that anybody ever said about that was people thought that it was forced, that he was doing that, what he did, just for the cameras. But I can't sit here and tell you that he was. I can't sit here and tell you that he wasn't.
I think if he wasn't a QB, he wouldn't be a locker room leader. He has to be a leader because of the position he plays.
No doubt.
But it's not natural for him.
Right, Frank Reich met with the media earlier today at the Combine. This is what he had to say about the future, and the future as in right now, of Carson Wentz in Indy.
Well, I haven't sat down with Mr. Ursay in a while. You know, I know I believe in Carson. You know, I believe in him. I stuck my neck out for him. You know, I stuck my neck out for him. So, you know, last year I was a big part of that decision to get him here. You know, I believe he's going to continue to have a lot of success at quarterback. That might be here. It might not be here. That decision has yet to be determined. But I still believe in the person. I still believe in the player, right? I mean, we're all in progress. I'm in progress. He's in progress. Every one of our players is in progress. You just don't want to get into that trap of taking a snapshot of any 1 week or 1 year. It's a bigger story than that, right? So the storyline is much bigger than one season. We've always had that perspective and we'll continue to.
Hey, we're all in progress, baby. I'm in progress. You're in progress. We're all in progress. That, again, that is evidence of answering a question that you don't want to answer right now and trying to spend as much time in answering the question and trying to get past the question without saying a word. I'm in the process. You're in the process. We're all in the process. Will, line four, you're in the process. Welcome to the show.
Jay, how you doing?
I'm great. Go ahead.
Just a couple quick comments. You know what I appreciate is you don't do a lot of hot takes.
I'm not a hot take guy.
You're not a hot take, but I tell you what, Jake Query's a hot take guy, and I'm still trying to get used to that morning show because listening to Kevin rein him in every day, and I like Jake a lot, but listening to Kevin rein him in, he's like, Kevin, if you had $3 million, would you buy a cheetah or an alpaca farm? And Kevin's like, dude, we're talking about the combine. So listen to reel him in every day is comedy. And I enjoy it. I enjoy listening to it.
No, did you answer the question? Would it be a cheetah or an alpaca farm?
he got back to the combine. But it's funny. Listening to his takes and analogies that only he understands.
Yeah.
Like, you're not going to get milk from a bull. And I'm like, what are you talking about? But it's comedy, dude. I enjoy it. I do.
Yeah. I will tell you this, man. I mean, everybody's got their own style. So,
and it's a good style, man. Yeah, it's a good
it's
style.
It's all good. I mean, he's been a friend of mine. He's been a friend of mine forever too. So, I'm riding with him. There are a lot of dudes I won't ride with. He's definitely one I would ride with always.
As far as the Colts go, I tell you what, Jim Irsay's not going to take a $15 million hit. He's a businessman. Carson Wentz is going to be the quarterback next season. I'm telling you that. He needs better receivers for sure. Instead of, like you said, if you had to watch Pascal come across the middle and drop another pass, a 10-yard pass, you were going to tear your TV off the wall. Same thing with Paris Campbell. He's made of glass. T.Y., he didn't play. He got a bunch of money for doing nothing. So the guy didn't have anybody to throw to. You can put any good quarterback in the NFL in the Colts and not have a receiver core, and you're not going to get anything out of it. You expect too much from a man with no weapons. It's the way it is. And he'll be back. I'm telling you, he will be back. He'll be the quarterback for the Colts this coming season, and that's just the way it is, period. Thanks for taking my call.
Will, thank you very much. I don't necessarily agree with that. I do like Jake. Man, they're not. I mean, there are some that I would ride with. There are some that I won't. He's one that I would ride with. Jim Irsay, did you see this? Just tweeted a Bob Dylan lyric. Man is opposed to fair play. He wants it all, and he wants it his way. But there's a woman on my block. She just sits there in the chill. Says, who is going to take away their license to kill? Now, you're saying, all right, so what? He does this all the time. No, the best part of it, or as Tony Katz would say, the popcorn moment here, is the responses. Get us Wilson. Announce the Wentz trade. It's beautiful. I love it. Get us Wilson. Announce the Wentz trade. Anything but this. It is outstanding. Here's what we need to do. This is your homework assignment from me tonight, and if I remember, I'll do it too. You guys can remind me. Let's all come up with a song lyric in reference to this situation. Got anything in mind? A song lyric in reference to this situation. You don't have to do this now. It's just a little homework assignment while you're sitting back and watching the Boilers play on the road at Wisconsin tonight. A song lyric. A song lyric in reference to or that accurately to you describes the situation. And then we'll all, you can tweet those at me and then like, yeah, I'm not going to say do that because some of you will be a jackass. Just tweet them all to me. JMV, can you politely inform people that $15 million to a billionaire is changed in the sofa? Because listen, he doesn't care about $15 million. That's why he's going to do it. He does not care. Let me rephrase. He cares about $15 million, but his belief in this team and the direction it is going far outweighs a 15 mil price tag. Mark Tinsley Jr. is absolutely right. Hey, don't go anywhere. I'll come back and we'll close it up with you next.
We upgraded. What do we upgrade? Our live streams. Find us at 107.5 The Fan on YouTube to watch, conversate, participate, and hang out with us in the new Hubler Studio today.
You know you work well together as a team. Now take your team to Royal Pin and make your next corporate event fun and affordable. Royal Pin Leisure Centers offer the perfect combination of food and fun for your next group event. At Royal Pin, you don't have to be a super athlete to have a blast. Everyone's on the team when you're bowling. Bowling is a fun, affordable way to socialize and compete with your colleagues. Create team spirit without meetings, reports, or deadlines. Just good times. And keep in mind, it's always cool in our non-smoking facilities. To get the ball rolling, call Royal Pin today at 465-8484 and we'll organize your next corporate event. Get ready to trade in your wingtips and heels for a pair of bowling shoes and have fun bowling.
set them up.
Knock them down. Send them flying, spinning round.
For more information, call 465-8484 or look us up at royalpen.com.
Royal Pen.
Hey, John, for Connecticut, let's get you the best water possible. Let's get you the best water possible. That's Connecticut Water with Joe, John, and Dennis today. I didn't really understand. Listen, I grew up on a well. I think what happened, like, I didn't grow up in Sleepy Eye or Walnut Grove, but I lived on a well. Basically, all water came out of the creek. I went down with a bucket every day and got in the creek and then put it in the tub and then rolled in the tub. No, seriously, it wasn't that bad, but it was bad. You know what clarified my well water? I had no idea how bad it was until I got the best, and that's Kinetico, the premier series water softener, the in-home drinking water station. It is fantastic. I had no idea how great it was going to be until I talked to Joe, John, and Dennis and my friends at Kinetico. If you don't have Kinetico water, you don't have the best. If you want the best, there are great deals out there for you right now at the two locations, Northeast Side Castleton, Southside US 31, and Southport Road. The Kinetico water app, download that to your device today and find out more on what you can save on accessories and bags of salt. Or for more info, that's KineticoND.com today.
BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks, unleashes the spirit of Las Vegas with BetMGM Rewards. Every time you make a wager at BetMGM, you can earn BetMGM Rewards points that you can redeem for online bonus credits like free bets and risk-free tokens. Planning a trip to Vegas? You can also convert your BetMGM points into MGM Rewards points that you can use towards dining, shows, and hotel rooms at over 20 MGM Resorts properties located on the Las Vegas Strip and nationwide. BetMGM Rewards is sports betting's premier loyalty program, featuring exclusive offers, incredible experiences, and valuable perks when you wager on the BetMGM app. Sign up with BetMGM or log on today to get an even bigger piece of the action with BetMGM Rewards. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. Must be 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana only. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Hey guys, looking for a reason to spend 3 days on the couch watching basketball? Schedule your vasectomy at Urology of Indiana for a Thursday or Friday, then sit back, relax, and catch some games over the weekend while you recover. It may be the only time your wife approves of hoarding the couch and the remote control. Vasectomies at Urology of Indiana are simple and typically take only about 15 minutes. Soon after, you'll be out the door and on your way home. During your recovery, you'll take ibuprofen and be back to your normal activities in 3 days. The docs at Urology of Indiana are board certified and perform vasectomies every day of the week, all year long. They're pros at what they do, and they have multiple vasectomy clinics, so chances are good there's one close to you. If you've been putting off your vasectomy, now is the time. You'll never have a better excuse to watch basketball. Call Urology of Indiana or visit vasectomyindy.com for information and to schedule an appointment. That's vasectomyindy.com.
Yeah, that's right. I bet you didn't expect to see me here. Well, here I am. Let me tell you about a little something called respect. You ever heard of it? You know, I think it's not...
You're good at using your time in the shower to replay conversations and say what you should have said. We're good at your insurance. Find an Indiana Farm Bureau insurance agent online, over the phone, or in person, and stop knocking on wood.
It's time for you to get out. You should just leave.
Hey, it's JMV. Race Trash Service is the largest independent recycling and waste solutions provider in the Indianapolis area, and right now, they're looking for great people to join the team. Race is a family-operated business and has been providing Central Indiana with industry-leading recycling and waste disposal solutions since 1965. They focus a lot on the culture to make it a great place to work. Go to racetrash.com to see the career opportunities waiting for you. That's racetrash.com today. Race, your recycling and waste solutions partner.
The Ride with JMV.
Can I buy you guys a drink? Guess not.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Good to be out of the rain. In the desert. Can we use these lyrics for the cold situation right now? America, horse with no name. My kid always says, you know what? When I hear a song from America, it reminds me of Florida on vacation. And you completely hammered inside the pool. Exactly. Me too. That's what I think. Here's what song I think about vacation and being drunk the entirety of the time in the pool without drowning is George Benson and Breezin'. Every single time I hear that song, that's exactly what I think about. That is George Benson and Breezin' is... That's vacation soundtrack to me. Brown County Music Center, the band America is coming. That is the month of June. Coming up, and it's going to be an absolute blast. I'm going to go, too, so we'll all be there together. June the 17th, that's on a Friday night. I can get down there. What's your email? That's June the 17th if you want to go. Number 9 is a winner. Thank you, Christian and the gang, by the way, down at the Brown County Music Center. That is going to be a blast. I believe that Gordon Lightfoot is going to be there too, which is also outstanding. Hey, give me Mike here at 239-1070. Mike, join the show. How are you?
Hey, how you doing, John?
I'm great. How are you, Mike?
Good, good. I was going to say, I'm a big America fan, and I seen him down Louisville about 4 years ago with the Louisville Symphony Orchestra down there. Pretty cool.
Yeah. I think that they were, right before the pandemic, they played down in Brown County too, right? So, awesome, man. It'll be a good show. What you got for me, bud?
Hey, I was just going to, the whole Carson Wentz thing, I think we ought to keep him another year and build around him, get him some more weapons. But, if we do trade him or get another quarterback, what about Huntley from the backup from the Ravens?
Yeah, I will say that. And, Mike, thank you for the call. I appreciate that. I don't know. This is just a guess. We were talking about this during the break. I don't know how great he would be outside of the Baltimore system. But that's just me faring a guess right now. Thank you for the call. I appreciate that. Again, I'm not a fan of Wentz being able to take them anywhere, but I'd like to see some sort of reasonable alternative at some point. We shall see. We'll continue to talk about this tomorrow. Both Ballard and Reich meeting with the media today. Rakestraw, Rab Johns, Blackman Podcast, 1075thefan.com. Boilers, Wisconsin, reaction with you coming up tomorrow as well. Kyle, great job. You guys are fantastic inside the lounge. Facebook Live and your calls today, outstanding. Way to go, baseball. Screwed us again. Back with you tomorrow at 3:00.